They're getting ready for Game 6 in Phoenix as Coyote fans are planning another whiteout in hopes their team can wipe out the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim and advance to the conference semifinals in their quest for the Cup. As we welcome you to the Fox Television Center here in Hollywood, California, I'm James Brown along with my partner, Dave Maloney. Now, before we get you to today's game in Phoenix, let's get you caught up on the action of other games already underway this afternoon, Dave.
That's for sure. In St. Louis, Brett Hull, who's been the Blues' best player in the series so far, goes 1-on-4 against the Red Wings. You can't lay your stick on Hull, or that's what happens. That was early on the power play. The Russian 5, again, nice puck movement. Kozlov tied at 1. Power play a factor at that point, tying the game up for the Red Wings here. Silva or Pierre Turgeon, not yet a factor. I believe the Blues do need him to be a factor to compete in this series.
All right, so that's up to the minute information.
Here we go. Let's go up to Edmonton. This ties the game up as Buchberger goes down the right side. Who pulls his way to front? Mike Greer. That was midway through the second period. All tied up. I'll tell you, Edmonton off the start, a little guilty of the exuberance of youth, taking too many penalties, but it doesn't matter if Dallas can't score, and they haven't scored in the power play yet.
All right, some tight game sixes there. And, folks, let's turn our attention back to the game at hand in Phoenix. And for that, we throw it out to our own Jigs McDonald, who's calling the action.
Thanks, JB. The Phoenix Coyotes have an opportunity to wrap up the series and advance to the conference semifinals with a win on home ice today. A week ago, Old Mo, as in momentum, showed up here, and he's hung around all week with the Coyotes, making it very difficult for the Mighty Ducks as these numbers bear out. So what does Ron Wilson's team have to do today?
Well, first of all, I think we're going to have to take the crowd out of the picture in the first 5 minutes. We're going to have to bend, not break. We're going to have to play solid defense in our end, and somehow we're going to have to generate offense, not from the Solane-Korea line, but somebody else has to chip in a goal today.
Coaches are always right. Only Correa and Salati have scored. Nothing for the rest of them as we get you back to Hollywood and you, JB.
All right, Jigs, thank you very much. And indeed, Phoenix's Keith Tkachuk has had an outstanding regular season, leading the league with 52 goals in a year. He is the guy that makes things happen for the Coyotes.
Well, there's certainly no question about that. In my mind, the big horse from Boston, Massachusetts, Keith Tkachuk, is our Fox faceoff guy here. This guy can flat out play. He does it down in the trenches. The old Ted Lindsay's, John Ferguson's, and Gordie Howe's, the history of this league, are proud of this guy. He's carrying on the tradition. 52 goals and 200-plus penalty minutes. Keith Tkachuk is only the fourth guy in the history of the league to get those types of numbers. JB, his game is down below, and I'll tell you, he doesn't mind throwing them either. His biggest problem, I believe, is playing in control. Like Brendan Shanahan and Owen Nolan, he represents a power forward in today's game. If indeed he stays in control, he is a guy the Coyotes have to have, their emotional and physical leader, Captain Keith Tkachuk. And I tell you, I flat out like the way he, Shanahan, both play. He's a player.
I know you like that grit he displays too, right?
Well, that's the thing. As they talk about now with the money and the finesse of the game, we spend a lot of times, a lot of the game is down low in the trenches and whacking them up. And Keith Tkachuk has no problem doing that.
All right, folks, keep in mind that you'll hear from Keith Tkachuk during the first intermission. And that'll do it for us from here. When we come back, we'll send you out to Game 6 between the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim and the Coyotes. Enjoy the first period. We'll see you back here at intermission.
Losing Game 5 at the Pond, the Ducks have lost home ice advantage. Now 3-2, the Mighty Ducks have become sitting Ducks. The Coyotes' ferocious checks and hits have clipped Anaheim's wings and have kept all the Ducks in a row. Today, the Coyotes look to hold court in Phoenix and win their fourth straight and advance to the conference semifinals. While the Ducks hope to fly into the Valley of the Sun and steal a win with hopes of a seventh game and fade the sea of white out. Fox Sports is thrilled to welcome you to the Coyotes Den. Another whiteout. Hockey is a warm weather sport.
It is a warm weather sport.
It's just absolutely crazy in this building today. The fans at
taken to this series like no other. The Phoenix Coyotes have won the last three games. The fans here today are ready to watch them wrap it up. Anaheim wants to send it back to Anaheim for one more.
And so much of what has happened is centered around the job that Jeremy Roenick has done on Tall Korea.
Yeah, the first couple of games, Korea and Solani were the story. But Jeremy Roenick has played brilliant hockey the last three games of this series. This will be the key matchup of the game. Whoever wins this matchup, that club will probably win the game.
Peter, would you agree the major difference between games 1 and 2, games 3, 4, and 5 has been the goaltending?
Like any playoff series that's this close, goaltending is going to be a huge key. In games 1 and 2 is here. In games 3, 4, 5, Happy Boone has been better, especially in the two games here in Phoenix, where he made 62 of 63 saves in those two games, including a 2-0 shutout. At the other end, Guy Hebert has got to get back the way he played the first two games. Interesting note, the club that has had the most shots on goal in this series has lost every game. The hot goaltender has been a big key.
It doesn't get any better than this. No matter which one of the 26 National Hockey League arenas you may visit over the course of the year, the referee this afternoon is Don Kolharski. Sweet Knox and Brad Lazarowicz to work the lines. The off-ice officials are from Los Angeles, the gentleman who handled the first two games at Anaheim. The Coyotes in white, defending the goal to the left. The Mighty Ducks in their dark traveling uniforms to the right, and they start brooching between Korea and Solani. Bob Corkin taking the draw, and here's Corkin with the puck. 3-on-3 as they come to the line. Kachuk-chuk, a high one is dropped by Hebert. Cleared aside by the defensive work. Turned in by Paul Korea. And Solani trying to wind up. And away from Kachuk, and now Korea shot it in from his own side of the center ice stripe. And an icing call against the Mighty Ducks. Well, we asked Jeremy Roenick about the job that's assigned to him, stopping Paul Kariya and his role in this game.
Well, I think my role is almost double-sided. I'm looked upon to go and bring a lot of the offense, and then on the flip side, when we don't have the puck, I have to watch that little fast guy, number 9, Kariya, to make sure he doesn't get too much room. So it's almost like a Selke and a wannabe Hart put together. But it's a tough job, and it's something that I look forward to every night to try and conquer. But there's a lot of pressure on me, and it's the way I like it. And if it was any different, I don't know if I would enjoy it as much.
The words of Jeremy Roenick, Selke Trophy, of course, for the best defensive player in the league. Nothing. Timberdowski's shot is off the blocking glove of Hebert and on into the whiteout.
It'll be very interesting to see how the Phoenix Coyotes react today to the crowd. This crowd was even louder today than it was last Sunday. Last Sunday, they used it to their advantage. They got 3 goals the first 14 minutes and basically put the game away. But sometimes, just when it's so loud, there's so much adrenaline, you can overplay your hand and get too deep, try to do too much. You're going to have to try to keep calm with all of this emotion outside.
And you heard Ron Wilson, the coach of the Mighty Ducks, say on our Fox Watch that they want to score first. They want to take the crowd out of this if they can. It may have been just a little bit of a delaying tactic by Janney as he has some tape removed. Yari Curry on the draw. Janney wins it. Tabardowski spins it wide to the net. There's Keith Kachuk. Wrapped around. The puck loose and cleared by Bellows. Sacco can't get to it in time. Janney nudged it back inside the zone. J.J. Daniel sets up for Anaheim. Vigalas clearing it to center ice. And it's shot right back in again. Daniel will try the other side of the ice.
For the Mighty Ducks, safe plays early. Even if they have to take a whistle, take an ice, just an offside, an icing, whatever. But don't let the momentum get started. Too much skating, too much quick pace right off the bat.
They've had 3 shots on goal thus far. If Ronnie accepts the pass, deep in the corner, and can't put it out in front. This is Joe Sacco for the Mighty Ducks. And off the boards. Anaheim in the middle of the player change, and Darren Quint is back for Phoenix. They put it in the corner for Jay Moore. Ahead for Ronning. He spotted Chris King on left wing. Parker is his right winger. Now Ronning have turned around. And a heavy hit. Big hit delivered on Ted Drury.
Stafford back. David Karpel sends it off the boards and bounced it actually right to goaltender Nikolai Abibolin. Coyotes have cleared it out. Here's David Karpel back. And Jury trying to cycle it up the boards and it wouldn't go, so an offside is called as Shannon handled it.
Jake, here's an interesting graphic. As we look at the penalty minutes per game, games 1 through 5, and you look, the series got more intense into game 3 here at Phoenix. But last game, right here, at Anaheim, both clubs only took 2 penalties. There were only 2 power plays. Disciplined hockey. And the clubs that can stay disciplined today are going to give themselves a real advantage. Neither club wants to have those power plays determine the outcome of this game.
Got a look here at both coaches. Game plan, game plan. I asked Don Hay yesterday, Peter, about changing anything. He said, no, don't plan to, and hasn't. Eberdoski. Knocking back as Van Imp shot it in. Van Imp back in the lineup. He's had out the last 2 games. Van Imp, number 29, waiting here at the point. But the puck is played back to the net. And the Coyotes are having trouble getting it out of there. Mike Stapleton around the boards. Away from Van Imp. Over going high in the air. Well, they try to come up the near boards. Marshall heads up, as is Baumgartner and the rest of the Mighty Ducks. The Coyotes unable to get out of the zone cleanly. Here's J.J. Daniel on the left side. Long shot is well wide of the net. Jeremy Roenick to play it. But right into the skates of Correa, who's lots of one high and wide of the net. Daymore taken out on the board. Sonati spun one in front, broken up. The Coyotes start out of there. And back to the play, a penalty being called by referee Koharski. Rutschen trying to get back on his skates after being knocked down, and Anaheim will get the first power play of the afternoon.
Steve Rutschen, who missed the first 3 games of this series with back spasms, very important member of this club. He centers the 2 big guys, Solani and Curry, and he has got to be in the lineup if they're going to be successful. You can see the back end right back there. There's the penalty. And Jake, we talked about discipline, and this is a kind of early swing that can really affect this hockey game.
Now we'll see if they can put it to work. The power play has been very good for the Mighty Ducks in this series. 5 power play goals on 23 opportunities in the first 5 games. Nothing if you've just joined us. Mighty Ducks in the dark uniforms. Daniel sent it around towards Solani's side of the ice, but instead it came off the back of the net. Here's Daniel. Brucher, you put it right between Correa's feet. Daniel and Mironov at the point. Mironov with it now. Makes the shot. Correa trying to get somebody open. Solani can't slip away from his check, so Mironov works it right back to Correa. And Mironov. Out of Correa, who takes up the right point position and starts in along the boards. Correa spotted Solani, who misfired. The puck bouncing as it came off one of the Phoenix players, and that long shot is underneath Nikolai Abibolin. He looked a couple of times, just stuck a peek over his left shoulder. There was no vulcanized rubber in the net.
Good puck control by the Mighty Ducks. They kept it to the outside. They couldn't get that free forward. So finally they decided to move the puck back to the defense and just get it on net. Good quick shot. You see Anaheim going to the front, but Abibolin was able to see it the whole way. That's always the key for a goaltender. If he can see the puck from the point, then he's going to make the save. You have to get people in front to screen or deflect.
1 minute, 15 seconds remaining in this power play. The numbers for the Ducks with an advantage in this series. Errol Gittick for Phoenix has left it around the boards and away from Daniel. Daniel veering off on the points. Rutschen centering for Solani and Correa. Daniel Singleton looking in the corner. The puck sent back to the net, and Jimmy Johnson will get to it. The Coyote is able to clear it out. Now 50 seconds left, as you see. Time remaining in the penalty against Jay Moore and Phoenix. Anaheim changing up their forwards on this power play. Here is Brian Bellows. Lots of playoff experience. And Daniel Tina. Murray with the even more playoff experience. The check. Nieminen did a nice job on him. Phoenix failed to clear it out. Now they get it out of the zone. And down the left side comes Dallas Drake. Got it off. The hard shot blocked by Amir. Short-handed opportunity. Jeremy Roenick. Center ice. Jari Kurri. Harding off the boards. 8 seconds remaining in the power play. Are going to clear it out of there. Hands counting down like New Year's Eve. The penalty kill is over.
Coach Wilson talked about that first 5 minutes.
Here's Bellows with a shot blocked by Avi Bowman. Big scoring chance, but nobody between Bellows and the goaltender. Nothing, nothing.
Great jump in this hockey for both of these two clubs. Now watch Roenick jump into the play, shorthanded. I mean, he is just flying up the side. And the key for both of these replays, I'm going to show you. The first one is going to be a save by Hubert. He's moving out, cuts down the angle, takes away so much from Roenick's shot. And then at the other end, Bellows breaks in. You see how he's going. He's out, he's aggressive. Both goaltenders look like they're very much on their game early in this hockey game.
7 shots thus far, 4 by Phoenix, 3 by Anaheim. Nothing, nothing to score as Daniel hustles back, touches up, and an icing call against the Phoenix Coyotes. Let's return to James Brown in our Fox Television Center for this NHL game break.
Jigs and Peter, Detroit capitalizing on a power play. It's a 4-on-2 here. Take a look at Tomas Sandstrom on the right. Throws the puck to the center there. Yes, indeed. Shanahan is there going to the net as he puts it past Fuhr. 2-1 Detroit, looking to close it out. Let's take it back to Jigs and Peter.
Only one series has been decided. Colorado last night beat Chicago 6-3. They eliminate them in 6 games. The other ones are all very much up for grabs. Right now, Colorado could play Edmonton, St. Louis, Phoenix, Anaheim. Nothing's been decided in the West.
How do you go about calling your travel agent, getting rooms in those cities? Or maybe you stay home. Here's Keith Tkachuk getting to center ice. It in. After it is Peredoski. The truck can't get back to it. Mighty Ducks with a chance to clear it out. Bobby Dallas didn't get it out of the zone. Tkachuk turned and fired, but it hit Daniel. Daniel, this one above the glass. Got a big hit after the clearing attempt as well. Coyotes failed to get it out of the zone. Anaheim unable to regain control, and 3 Coyotes move up. 3 Ducks get back. Look at the play by Jenny, and then a backhander falling on the play with Johnson. Large portion of this crowd trying to get a penalty call. And now hard down the boards. Heard all the way down by Ted Drury. Icing call coming against the Mighty Ducks. Lots of time remaining in the first period, but Ron Wilson wanted to get through the first 5 minutes. He's done that. Here's what's happened in the series, beginning with game one.
We start off in the pond, game one. Game two, Anaheim again. Then finally back here, the momentum starts to switch. Shannon, a big game. And Holly Bowen takes over game four. And finally, the first road victory. Corkum comes up with a big game.
That brings us to this afternoon, game six, with the Coyotes leading 3-2. And yes, the Berlin Wall has been erected here in Phoenix.
There is so much emotion out there right now. There's been 5 or 6 plays behind the play. Guys punching each other in the head, getting the sticks up, but they're trying their best to control themselves. But Jigs, right now, game six, first time someone can be eliminated. You know the stakes are getting higher and higher with each passing minute.
Oh, misfire there by Nieminen. Yeah, players, coaches, management will tell you the most difficult game to win is the deciding game, and Anaheim just failed to take the lead as Salani was set up perfectly. Puck bounced off Mironov. He's outside the line, dumped back in. Outside being delayed. Phoenix with a chance to move it out, and they did. Nieminen played it off the boards and all the way down for a icing call. Good scoring opportunities for the Ducks.
This is why Solani is so difficult to cover. When you watch this play, watch Solani. Right there, he breaks away from his man. He was tied up, but he's so strong. He's 6 foot, 200 pounds. Great balance, great strength. Like Forsberg for Colorado. You think you have him, but that strength combined with the speed. And right there, Javi Bula makes the first key save of this hockey game.
Bartini, the finish flash, I should say, is something special, isn't he?
Second leading scorer in the league this season. Everyone talked about Curry and him being on the line. They weren't making the playoffs without the sensational play of Solani this season.
Nicky, the Boulin Wall, they're calling him here. Shot 62 of the 63 shots against him in this building in the games 3 and 4, and has stopped 4 shots this afternoon. Face off to his right. Richard Park on the draw. Pad save by Javi Boulin. That was Darren Van Imp moving in from the point and putting it right on. He and Marshall are teamed up on defense. Now Jimmy Johnson back for the Coyotes. And a takedown. There's going to be a penalty call. A slash is signaled and Johnson is hurting. But the Coyotes are going to go to the power play. Their first opportunity trying to get the lead in this game.
Oof. Jimmy Johnson been taken off by the training staff. 2 minutes on Warren Reichel. There's the slash right there across the back of the legs. And then just after all of this, there is a little interplay between the Anaheim Mighty Ducks on the ice and the Phoenix players on the bench. And again, everything's starting to boil. Composure, discipline right now is going to become a key.
Absolutely. Teppo Numminen got one underway. Johnson, by the way, went right to the Phoenix dressing room. Able to move the puck. Rodding gets it back to Teberdoski. Do a screen and wide. Hebert decides to slow things up and get a face off. And Rodding accepts a punch and then just skates away. Not going to get involved at all with Bobby Dallas. Specialty teams so important to playoff time, and these Coyotes trying to find theirs.
You see them 0 for the last 12. The Coyotes, even though they've won the last 3 games. And Jace, when things aren't going well in the power play, you simplify. Get it back to the point, one touch the puck, get it on net. And I think you're going to see the Coyotes, when Numminen, Teberdoski get the puck at the point, they may not be looking for the fancy play, just drive towards the net, get the puck on net.
That's the key. Go for a rebound, but make sure you get it on the net. Face off, won by Rodick. Teberdoski shot right into the Mighty Duck crest, and then dropped into the top of the pads.
Teberdoski, who's had a struggle a little in this series. Remember, Teberdoski was originally drafted by the Anaheim Mighty Ducks, and they went over in a big trade last year when Solani came to Anaheim, and he made some comments. He didn't know they were being recorded at the time, but they got out the press about how he hated Anaheim, didn't like the players, they didn't have much talent. You see, he was fourth leading defenseman scorer during the regular season. He has but one assist so far in the playoffs.
Open mouth, insert foot, and try and get back on track.
Very sensitive kid, and it was the people's reaction in Anaheim. He did not expect it. The players for Anaheim, I mean, they took their run. That's to be expected. He didn't expect the booing from the crowd.
Phoenix unable to complete a pass on that opportunity to move through center ice, and Mironov put it right on Javi Boulin. The ice comes Teberdoski. Plays it through the defense. No trouble gaining the blue line, but now the Mighty Ducks gave it away, and Jenny sets up Kachuk, who couldn't handle it. Mighty Ducks can't clear it out either. The opportunity was there. Teberdoski to Numminen, kept it right on the blue, fires and just missed the net. David Karpa slams it off the board, sending Phoenix all the way back. 24 seconds left in this power play.
You can see what happens when you don't get that puck out of the zone. Everybody expects you to go out of the zone, all of a sudden you're going to have chaos. So get it out, down the board, what Karpa just did.
And hit it back the other way, shot it in. Tidied up, shoot it out. Rodding was back and has given it to Dinnick. Rodding, two men back, trying to go wide. Up the slot, the shot is blocked. Loose puck, oh, two big stops. And a penalty call coming as well. Hebert stood tall. And back to the goal. There's the scene with Dallas and Drake. It is still 0-0 on the scoreboard.
since one of those little things behind the plate, chances lost to stick. That's why there's four Anaheim players and only two. Four Phoenix players, only two Anaheim in down low. Hebert, his best play. Jiggs, you can see the traffic that goaltenders have to face game after game. Look at the Phoenix players in the net, in the area, Anaheim players. We have eight guys within about 2 feet of Guy Hebert.
So you're saying it wouldn't have counted had it gone in anyway, right?
Well, it would have been looked at.
Yes, you know it.
We know that.
Dallas for roughing at 9:04 of this first period. Second power play of the afternoon for the Coyotes. And you know the story. Now 0 for their last 13 attempts. Close to 17,000. That's for Darren Shannon, of course. Cannons Canyon. On A saying now it is indeed the Coyotes' den. Oh yeah, this was home for and still is for the Phoenix Suns. This was their place. Hockey moved in last ball.
Look at the numbers for Phoenix. Minute 13. That's a pretty good amount of time to have the puck in. They had some good opportunities, but only two shots got through. Players played desperate hockey in playoffs. You'll see an awful lot of block shots.
Nothing more difficult, as I said before, than trying to end the series. Put it away. The most difficult victory, the fourth. Roenick running. Richard moving up. Came back to the blue line. Held in there by Tavernoski to running. Running to Tavernoski. Up the slot. Just missed. Big rebound. Quick shot is blocked. And quick. The Gardner as he went back in the net. Right at the side of the goal. Up, up. Didn't tip it over all the way. Clock stopped with 10 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the first period.
Jake's one of those little things to watch for. Players are trying to draw a penalty. And so many times it'll be retaliation that draws the penalty. So they're going to bump into guys and sort of try and stare them down, hoping they get a little poke in the head to draw that extra minor. And again, watch right in front of the net. All the action that goes on. Puck goes back to the point and then it goes back there. Everyone starts going towards the middle. But Gardner's in there. He just couldn't get the tip. Gardner, who has a couple goals in this series, just can't quite sneak it in. But Hebert has looked sharp here in the first 10 minutes of this hockey game.
Very focused. You had a look at Mike Gardner, one of the oldest players in the National Hockey League, and one of the most productive in the history of the sport. Chuck on the draw, lost the faceoff, and the Ducks turn it around to the near side, held in, Tavernoski to Janney. Make the good pass work for Tkachuk, number 7. Marshall battling Tkachuk. And on the play was Jabby to Tkachuk. Keith Tkachuk got it back. Tavernoski gave it to him again at the top of the circle. Better shooting position. Nice stop by Hebert.
I mean, that really was a brilliant save because Tkachuk has a great wrist shot. Twice it looked like he was going to shoot. And each time Hebert had to adjust and move and still keep his angle on Tkachuk. Now watch Tkachuk right there. It looks like he's going to shoot. And then there. And then finally he takes the extra step. And Hebert just smoothly moved across and stayed focused on the puck. Tkachuk, who tied with a couple other players, leads the playoff goal scorers at 5. And you see before this in 19 playoff games, he only had 8 goals. So again, this was a breakout season. For Tkachuk, he led the National Hockey League in goals during the regular season, continuing right on into the playoffs.
Had a goal in Game 1 and Game 2 at Anaheim. Another one here last Sunday, of course, for 3 games in a row, was blanked in their shutout victory, and then fired 2 home in Game 5 with the Pawn. Had 27 shots on goal coming into today's game. Anaheim killing off this penalty, able to send it down the ice. Tavernoski is back. Dallas, remember, is sitting out a roughing penalty. Tavernoski with Keith Tkachuk. Can't get it off the board, getting it away from Sackle, but David Puck is there. And he got away from Janney, finds a seam, and the puck bounces all the way down. Rebulin's heading it up for Tepadoski. 30 seconds of the power play. Tepadoski tries the left side. And Quint got over the Anaheim line. Up the boards to Jenny. The move on Curry. Then Kachuk didn't hold the puck. Jenny lost it, and Yari Curry has cleared the zone. Broken stick for Quint. And to drop that, and this gives Solani an opportunity. Couldn't finish it off, but a takedown on Solani and a penalty called against Phoenix. Jeremy Roenick goes to the penalty box.
The penalty killing of Anaheim comes up big, and now one little turnover, and it goes back. Jigsboro looking and waiting for that momentum to switch or start or change in this hockey game. Both clubs now have had a couple of power plays. Where's Ronan's reaction to the call? Is he an animated guy or what? Before the game, we're sitting up here watching, and there's somebody down the runway talking with the fans. Got your binoculars and looked, and there's Jeremy Roenick talking with the fans, you know, shaking hands, just sort of, you know, you can see excited, but, you know, still out there, as he likes to do, just talking with the people.
He is a character and one of the all-time good guys. And a bunch of the Boston click, can I call it? It's not really a click, but the Boston group played golf on Friday. Day off for that team, the Coyotes. How'd you do? Played with Kachuk. He said, oh, he said, I was never on the fairway, but part every hole. Daniels in. Got cleared away and shot out of there. Minute and a half remaining in the Anaheim power play. We're waiting for the first goal of the afternoon. Mironov brings the Anaheim Mighty Ducks across the line. Ran out of room, but has been able to buy some more, and then fires and saved. That one really popped the leather. Jabbing at it. And it is underneath the Anaheim player, the Mighty Ducks player, hitting the space Jake off today.
Look at this, Mironov hurt. Now remember, Phoenix has already lost Johnson. I don't know if he has returned to the bench. But Mironov went down on a hard hit by Ruchin.
Neuvonen. Yeah.
Appears to be okay.
Hello, Neuvonen.
He's had a very good series for Phoenix. Been their best defenseman and has contributed offensively. You look at this, 5 games in the playoffs, 3 goals. During the whole regular season, he played 82 games, only 2 goals. One of the reasons, Jigs, this year, because he's a very good offensive player, but this was the breakout year for number 20, Tepadoski. And they asked Neuvonen to put his ego and his stats aside and just be that stay-home defenseman, that guy that, you know, handled all the two-on-ones. Let Tepadoski test the waters, get out there, rush the puck. Tepadoski had a great season, and Neuvonen was a big part of it.
Speaking of seasons, I guess it had too much of Seinfeld. Here enough for the drive, blocked by Javi Bullen. A Bullen wall there when they needed him. It's around the board by Stapleton. They don't get it out. Mironov is checked, and now they are out of there. Here's Mike Stapleton to center. Lost it to J.J. Daniel. Corkin coming up with him, trying to make the play. And 3 Ducks over to handle this. Mike Stapleton, and now the fourth arrives, and the puck goes loose. The fourth one happened to be Correa. Now Timo Solani winding up. Up through the middle. Daniel moves up as well. The pass to Correa took him off the board. Gave it to Mironov. Split it. Daniel in a hard collision with Gartner. God love that. Mironov feeds it off. Korea shot. Oh, it's in the catching glove. Wow.
Jakes, the 3 games that have been played here was a 4-1 win by Phoenix, but 4 of the goals came in the first period. The next game was 2-0 with an empty net goal. So there haven't been a lot of goals, but there's been incredible action in this series here in Phoenix. Look at this kid. I don't think there's a shooter in the league that prepares better before he gets the puck in Korea. He is so ready to shoot the puck when he gets the puck. And it's that extra split second that makes him maybe the best pure shooter in the game today.
And eight shots on goal in the first game of this series. Four in each of the next two. Four here. And home, I should say. And then only one in game five at the pond. Back from the point, blocked by Javi Bullen. Big rebound, and it's cleared out of there. Nice job turned in by Corkum. And now Shannon in the forecheck. Games are at full strength again. Nothing, nothing is our score. Wallace moving headed across. Harpa hard in off the boards. Didn't rebound this time for Sacco. Right up the boards. Jay Moore, and it came to center ice. Anaheim waiting to get it back onside, and the Marshall shot it in. Ari Curry goes for it. Backhands it. He's going wide. Bobby Bullen decided to hold on to it. Get the clock stopped. Probably a player change, too. Ottawa at home tonight with Buffalo. Chance to wrap it up. Bob Corkin has dropped the puck. Coyotes out of there. Moore has shot it in from center. A high shot grabbed and dropped off. Benny Bear, seeing the man barreling right in on him, decided to hold on as Jim McKenzie was coming quickly. Well, next Sunday, playoff action continues on Fox. We don't know where any of the crews are going to be, but there will be action. Beginning at 2 o'clock Eastern Time, the Stanley Cup Conference Semifinals. Check your local listings and stay abreast of what's going on right here on Fox.
The league goes from 26 teams to 16 in playoff time. They've chopped off eight by next Sunday. It'll be down to eight teams that all believe they have a shot to win the Stanley Cup. So things, as intense as the first round is, they just pick up with each round.
And of course, playoffs underway in the other leagues, the American Hockey League, the International League, Central, and so on. Puck has been cleared out to center ice. Gerald Dinnick back for Phoenix. Now Newman off the board. Shannon has cleared it to the line, and Mirnoff moves it up quickly. Here's Correa with Solani, who got knocked off balance. And that allowed Shannon to handle it, and Corkum has shot it in wide. Just under 6 minutes to play in a scoreless first period. 11 shots on goal for Anaheim, 8 for Phoenix. Tarpa, veteran defenseman. Mirnoff back to Tarpa. That's over center, shoots one deep into the zone. Bobby Bullen set it up. Apple Lumina looks up ice. Sees his former roommate when he was with Winnipeg, Abel Solani, standing there. So he tried the other side of the ice. Nothing doing for Corkum. Well, he clogged things up in the middle, in the center ice area. Don't give him a chance to complete that first pass. They're doing the job. Defensively, that is. Now it's lifted high in the air by Dinnick. That gets it out through center, but they're not in control of it. Gabriel goes back. Here's King, rolled him into the corner. Here's Ronning. Unable to get it back to Gartner until now. And it's loose for Ronning. Had one block out and another one. Jansen's has cleared it out.
Little Cliff Ronning, all 5'7" of him, who was the real star in game three with three assists. He's the kind of spark plug player that can really ignite a crowd. And I'm going to watch him.
Good news for Coyote fans. Jimmy Johnson is okay. He's back out on the ice now. Petrovsky leads the rush. Fires one that didn't get to the net, but Ronning was there. Cliff Ronning with King clogging things up. Gartner's shot changed direction. Hey there. Reels it back in, covers for a face-off. We'll be right back. Very creative, aren't they? Must have stayed up late.
And the crowd again, as they did last week. The games, every time somebody walked in with an Anaheim Mighty Duck jersey on, they got booed and booed out of the building. The crowd is having a lot of fun with this whole whiteout thing.
Take a look at scores around. Dallas and Edmonton are even. Detroit leading. On to baseball, where the Jays lost today. Yankees leading at the top of the seventh. Play call back here. Face-off coming. 4:13, the time remaining in the opening period. I'm Jinx McDonald with Peter McNabb, and glad you're able to join us. Phoenix poised to capture the series. And, of course, Anaheim wanting to take it to the limit. Force it back for a Game 7, which would be at the pond on Tuesday night.
Oh, the Cubbies. Huh.
Not been a great time in Chicago, aside from the Bulls.
Yeah.
The Bulls are saving the sports scene there right now.
And Chuck just won the draw for Phoenix, and Dabrowski has moved it out. Dallas Drake banks it off the boards. Back with lots of time for Chuck to get on him, and it's cleared out. Here's Danny, and he has dropped it for Johnson. Up into the middle, but Curry read it well, and then his pass went behind Sacco. And he shot down the ice.
The pressure is starting to build a little bit on the forwards for Anaheim. Korea and Solani have scored 8 goals between them. No forwards have scored a single goal. And if they're not going to win this game, if you have to rely on just 2 guys, so the other guys are going to have to think a little bit of offense as we get into this game.
Ron Wilson said at the outset, the first 5 minutes would be key. Take the crowd out of it, hopefully get a goal. They didn't get the goal, but they kept it even. Now the clock has stopped. The puck jammed up against the boards long enough to get a face-off. 3:19 left in the period.
Brian Bellows and Curry are the 2 guys with the experience that know what needs to be done in situations like this. Bellows, go to the front of that. Be strong. Get a rebound. That's his forte. Curry, be creative. Try to pick that one play. Make that one move. You know Koharski is not going to make calls right here. Don Koharski, one of the best referees in the league. He knows the game. He knows what's going on. He's going to make the right call at the right time.
And that little takedown on Dallas Drake wasn't going to get a penalty call. This is Steve Richin. Shooting it in wide with the net as you saw. Bo Numinen turns it around the board for 7, and immediately Solani bumped him off the puck. Anaheim said they would play more physical in Game 5. I didn't think they lived up to their advanced billing in that department. Here they throw the body checks very well in the opening period of today's game. Daniel is back to handle it. Bobby Dallas, he's number 2 for Anaheim. Here's Teemu Solani. Hands it in well wide of the net. Luminen making the exchange with Harvey Bullen. They try Shannon on left wing. Cross ice pass, but up a little too far for Roenick. Gerald Dinnick shoots it in. Both teams are in the middle of the player changes. 2:20 left in the first period. Nothing to score. Van Hip. And Baumgartner puts it in the far corner. That's Johnson back. Now the veteran Mike Gartner backs one off the glass. That's going to go all the way down the ice. Next sound you hear. Whistle. And we'll be back after this. Coming up on the first intermission, the new Dodge Report. James Brown and Dave Maloney will bring you all the scores, highlights from the other games today. And we'll catch up with Keith Tkachuk and get his view of the series. That's all coming up on our first intermission report.
Tkachuk, one of the most interesting guys, 25-year-old captain of these Phoenix Coyotes. He's one of those guys that you build a franchise around. He's big, strong, tough, doesn't care who he's playing, how he's playing. He's just going to get out there and win your hockey games.
Build superstar status around him, now with Barry Lemieux retiring and so on.
Absolutely. He, along with Yager and Ford with Korea, these are the charisma guys of the league.
Find out if he wants to accept that role as part of our first intermission. Harper over for Anaheim, a minute and a half to play in this first period. Coyotes in the middle of a change. Pass broken up and Lourdes backed it in. Here's Mike Gartner back to Martin and to his feet. Harper with a backhand pass up to Ken Baumgartner. Oh, big collision with Moore. Does end up in the Phoenix territory. Again, they're making quick changes. Numinen off the boards to get it out of there. Jumped over the stick of Dallas. He's back on it now. This is Curry. Jansen, the pass off to Dinnick. Dallas brings out back outside and put it right back in. We're in the final minute. The opening period, Game 6. Western Conference quarterfinals in the National Hockey League Stanley Cup playoffs. Phoenix win today and they win the series. If Anaheim wins, they go back to the pond for Game 7. They don't get much better than a 7-game series, even if it is the first round. Ask Ron Wilson today about good luck charms. Anything special? I said, if I came to the bench, went through your jacket pocket, is there a good luck charm there? Yeah, there is. Here's what it is.
Tell you that it's in his breast pocket.
Thing I carry with me to every game is my dad's rookie card. It's a 53 rookie card from the Detroit Red Wings, and during the national anthem, I always take it out and put it over my heart, say a little prayer, hope my dad is looking down upon me, think about my uncle sitting back, hopefully watching the game in Detroit, and that they'll sort of rub their hands and give me a little bit of luck, because we're going to need it today in here.
Ron Wilson, his dad was Larry Wilson, died of a heart attack 6-7 years ago, and his uncle that he referred to was Johnny Wilson with the Detroit Red Wings. Also coached the Los Angeles Kings briefly, and was once the Iron Man of the National Hockey League. He's had some more heart surgery recently, Johnny, and we wish him well. Veronik able to make contact with the puck, so there won't be an icing call, and the opening period is quickly coming to a close. The puck stayed in the zone, however, and Veronik tries to buy some room. A backhander by Pocum. What a block by Paul Kariya. Sacrificing, blocking that backhander, and the first period is over.
You know, a lot of people would say nothing would be a boring period. That was a sensational period of intense playoff hockey.
Now back to JP and Dave for the new Dodge Intermission Report after these words.
I'd like to remind you to play the Quaker State Get Cup Crazy game. Watch the Stanley Cup playoff game on May 18th on Fox to see if you've won a trip to the 1998 NHL All-Star Game. Phoenix Coyote fans can expect many future All-Star appearances from left winger Keith Tkachuk. The NHL's leading goal scorer recently sat down for a chat with our Jigs McDonald.
Thanks, JB. We're with the captain of the Phoenix Coyotes, Keith Tkachuk. Keith, how important is it for this franchise to win the series over the Mighty Ducks and establish something here in Phoenix in your first year?
Well, it's huge. I mean, for us to be in Phoenix for the first time, you know, to get the fan support, I think it's great for our organization to make that step to get more into the playoffs, and especially for me, who I haven't been past the first round yet since I've been in the organization. So it'd be nice to get out of this first round, but it's going to be really tough, but hopefully we're capable of doing it.
Have you been able to feed off the crowd and the whiteout that's been going on here?
It's been great. I mean, the support we've been getting, you know, sellouts even towards the end of the season, especially in the playoffs with the whiteout, it's been so loud. The people are so much into it, and we're excited, and it makes us obviously play a lot better at home, especially when we didn't have very many wins at home during the regular season.
Keith, how important was it to win the scoring title, the most goals in the league, and become the first American to lead the league in that department?
Well, that's nice. I mean, it's nice to accomplish something like that. I didn't know the actual stats of being the first American, but I just want to go out and play my game, not worry about scoring goals all the time. But I trade that in for a Stanley Cup any day. I want to be known as a winner, not as a 50-goal scorer.
With Mario Lemieux retiring at the end of the season, Wayne Gretzky obviously in the twilight of his career, is it Keith Tkachuk's turn to step up, take center stage, and load the league on his shoulders now?
Well, it's nice, but nobody will ever take the place of Wayne Gretzky and Mario Lemieux, what they've done for this game. If it wasn't for them, the game wouldn't be where it is today. And it is time for some of the younger guys to step up, guys like Kariya and Lindros, to be the next generation. So I'm not too worried about that. I just got to go out and play my game, and hopefully good things will happen.
Tell me, who's, in your opinion, the best player on this Coyote team?
Well, I mean, probably has to be a goaltender, Nicky Habibulin. I mean, he's the guy that's going to lead us. He's the guy that's going to make or break us in the series. And, you know, the first and second game, he might have struggled a little bit, but he's bounced back big time for us, and that's why we won 3 games in a row. And, you know, we need a solid goaltender if we want to go far in the playoffs, too.
Has anyone in this series, anyone on the Anaheim team in particular, impressed you with the level at which they brought their game?
Well, I think they're a solid team. I mean, obviously they're led by Kariya and Solani, but Hebert's been playing well for them. But they're a great team. Other guys obviously are counting on to score goals for them. But they're solid. They play physical, and they're strong back there on the blue line. It's been a heck of a series, and hopefully we can end it.
Now Keith Tkachuk and his team scoreless with Anaheim after one period. Oh, there's baseball coming. Football's here. Basketball, hockey, baseball in this great stadium just down the street from where we are this afternoon. We'll be back right after these words.
Well, they're not dead Ducks yet. Neither team scored in the first period this afternoon as we welcome you back to the America West Arena. Time to take a look at the Bud Ice stats. Statistics brought to you by Bud Ice.
Anaheim out shooting the Phoenix Coyotes that first period, but only two real good scoring chances for both clubs. That was because of hard work, Jigs. Everybody was hustling back in the defensive zone, but the Stars had maybe the best two chances for each of the clubs. Killing a penalty, Roenick breaking down the left side. He's a right-handed shot. He walks in, but Hebert moves out, cuts down the angle, takes away the scoring opportunity. At the other end, we're going to see a great shot of Creel. Watch this guy's preparation. The hands are high. They slide down. The puck is there. He's ready to shoot. Javi Bulin's best save of that first period. And this is how intense it was. Watch on the left side of your screen. Here comes Roenick. Bang. Knocks the man down. Puck goes down to Roenick. Everyone drives towards the net. Watch right in front of Hebert. This man right here. As the puck turns around, that's Rutschman. He reaches out and kicks it out of the way. That's the way this entire first period was played. Jigs, that's the way this game is going to continue to be played.
Catch front. Nothing, nothing score. Indicates a perfect game.
And Paul Kariya, every one of his six even strength shifts in the first period, Jeremy Roenick was on the ice. The shadow knows where Kariya is.
Six even strength shifts. Wow. Now there is JR. You know, all set for period two.
You grow to begrudgingly like and hate the guy that you're playing against in situations like that. You know, I've watched players shadow players, and it is becomes, over the course of a long series, so intensely personal. I'm not going to let you beat me. During most of the season, it's always team stuff. That becomes very personal.
On the draw here, the Mighty Ducks in control of the puck. We talk about shadows. The name Brian Watson pops into my mind. What association do you make with that name?
Mr. Bobby Hull?
Yeah. On him all the time in the playoffs. The Bull. Hey! Coyotes trying to get the lead here, but the puck found its way to Paul Kariya. He's got good speed. Trying to move in around Dinnick. Shot! Oh, just enough of it for Javi Bulin. Up they come. At the other end, it's Roenick. Dallas cut in front of them. Roenick drops it. Couldn't get it to Corkum. Bob Corkum, the former Mighty Duck, put it behind the net. Dallas turns it to the near side, and J.J. Daniel got it out of the zone. Off Rutschman, and the play call. It is a speed game, isn't it?
It's a speed game. The players in the National Hockey League never skated faster, but this may be the quickest player in the game. Right now, the defenseman has got no option but to give him a little bit of the outside. If they cut towards Kariya at all, he's going to dance to the inside. No, folks, that's not speed it up at all. That's just Kariya in mid-flight. Nightmare for a defenseman.
Isn't it? The defenseman was Gerald Dinnick in this case, an acquisition by the Coyotes from Hartford at the trading deadline. Numbers for Paul. His first visit to the Stanley Cup playoffs.
It'll be interesting to talk to Kariya when the playoffs are over as to what he felt, how he felt they were different than maybe he expected them to be.
Right now, Chuck is out with Drake and Janney. Tverdovsky and Johnson on defense. Oleg Tverdovsky just got it out of the zone. Anaheim able to nudge it back. Got Bellows, Curry, and Sacco together. Here's Johnson stepping up for a loose puck. Jimmy Johnson turned it over, and David Karpa almost handed it back to him, and instead it's handled here by Sacco. Trying to get better position, and the shot turned aside, as you saw. Dallas Drake's outlet went right to Janney, and here's Mironov setting up at center ice. To Bellows, who tipped it into the zone. Kraski hit solidly after he cleared it. Anaheim waiting, buying time, didn't get the play back onside. Jansen's rushed it just enough to bring the call. Now he's hearing from Jim Johnson.
Well, he shoveled the puck on Javi Bulin after the whistle. Again, a little mind game, Jake. Right now, both teams.
Bellows claiming he was deaf.
Tverdovsky, that's what you have to do. See, Sacco, pardon me, kept the stick down. You get that stick up, that's when the referee, get the stick of the elbows up, you're just begging the referee to make a call. But if you keep it down like that, you can punish the man, you can forecheck. A lot of hits so far in this hockey game, but that's the way to do it.
Jansen's also acquired from the Hartford Whalers in a deal that the Mighty Ducks were able to pull off. Phoenix hasn't had a shot on goal in a long, long time. There are shots elsewhere. They're in the third with the Red Wings leading the Blues, trying to put that series away. This one, Dallas and Edmonton, just as tight a series, tough a series as anyone could have expected. Or maybe you didn't expect that Edmonton would be in a position to win the series today.
Absolutely not. Dallas, I thought, was a heavy favorite. Just as big a favorite as Colorado was against Chicago.
That one went six games. Finally, a team won in the other team's building. Last night, with Colorado putting that away. Here's Chris King for Phoenix, unable to center it cleanly. Then Ronnie got bounced around. Mighty Ducks trying to come out of the zone on that pass by Jansen's. Got in by Drury. Jansen's has gone back to the net. Couldn't get the puck to him. Nickelbeams in the lineup here. And here, Coyotes. That's Mike Gartner driving wide on Daniel and shooting it back wide and high. King spun one toward the net. Got through, but didn't get the ricochet they were looking for. And Ronning taps it in deeper. Mighty Ducks unable to clear it out. Kudoski spotted Chris King. King, nice setup for Ronning, who fires and missed the target. Johnson in deeper. Gartner trying to knock it away from Panik. It's turned to the far side of the ice. Out of there and all the way down. Again, the Ducks have iced the puck, stopping the clock with just a tick more than 17 minutes to play in the second period. And still we await the first goal of Game 6 in this series.
At BASF, we don't make the cooler. We make it cooler. We don't make the jeans. We make them bluer. We don't make the toys. We make them tougher. We don't make the water scooter. We make it lighter. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy. We make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
The general manager of the Phoenix Coyotes, Bob Smith. Great for the Minnesota North Stars, finished up his career with the Montreal Canadiens, and then replaced John Paddock. General manager of the squad, along with his other duties. Much credit has to be given to John Paddock, too, for settling the team that came here from Winnipeg. Some of the deals were made. Acquisition, loan exciting, of course, in the offseason. Now the puck tipped out of play and the clock stopped. It's still nothing, nothing. Glad you're with us on Fox Sports.
Jiggs, these are the plays right here that Correa wouldn't have made his first couple of years, but he's learned. He has to go after those that are coming after him. He uses his stick better now. He uses his body better now. He's certainly not a dirty player, but he's becoming more and more aggressive as he gets more and more attention in the league.
Maturity, learning the game at this level. It's all there for the former Hobey Baker Award winner, the best collegiate player in all of the NCAA ranks.
And remember, he missed the World Cup for Canada this year. He is going to be a big part of the Olympics and Canada's hopes next year for a gold medal.
Yes, sir. And here's another American hope taking the face off, Keith Tkachuk. He's been there in France in the Olympics of 92 at Albertville. Kind of excited about going back as well. Here is Tkachuk across the Anaheim line off left wing. Cruises in, center. Couldn't get it there in time. He was forced to go wide. Nice defensive play by Carpa. Back on the Mighty Ducks. Lani dropped it off. Went to Marinoff and a shot steered aside. And up they come, 2-on-1. Odd man rush. Carpa moves up. Carpa couldn't get the pass to his teammate in time. And then the big collision. Off went the goal. And Hebert's all right. Shane Doan is okay as well.
Corkum, who was the hero, really, of games 4 and 5 for Phoenix, has a 2-on-1 with Doan. Anaheim forcing the play. Jake's one of the few odd man rushes we've seen in this hockey game. Corkum goes across, looks to make the little drop pass. Beautifully read. Good hustle by Anaheim to get back. And again, hard work negating an offensive scoring chance. And I think that's really been the highlight of this game so far for both clubs. The work ethic defensively.
I think you're right. That may be the first odd man rush of the game.
Corkum, who had the first goal in that 2-0 win here in game four, that proved to be the game winner. Last game, a 5-2 victory by Phoenix. A goal and 2 assists. And of course, remember, he was an original Mighty Duck who just left the club last year.
He's all set to take the faceoff as we look over the shoulders of the Coyotes on their players' bench. Corkum won the draw. Dinnick into the corner. Cannon up to Corkum. The shot was wide. Salani trying to get it out of there. And it did get to center. Correa fed it across, and the long shot is knocked out of the air. Left one taken by Bobby Dolas. And now a takedown and a penalty being called against the Coyotes defenseman Gerald Dinnick. Let's return to James Brown at our Fox Television Center for this NHL game break.
Hey, James, is this a clean faceoff winning goal or what for Edmonton? Take a look. Lindgren with the win on the faceoff to Tarkowski. Boy, couldn't be any faster. Hey, Jiggs, Peter McNabb never lost a faceoff like that, did he?
Not that I remember, JB. No, I don't think so.
Jiggs, that's the most embarrassing thing in the world, to lose him that quick. Oh, man, you just feel like dirt standing there. There's nowhere to hide. You know, it's your fault. Get off the ice fast. But Edmonton stays in that series. There's a penalty down low. Left side, you just see the big rear end of Dinnick come out, knocks down Solani. Koharski right there. And with each passing moment, this game gets more and more intense.
Following the same script as we saw in game four of the series, nothing, nothing after one, after two, into the third, and then of course an empty netter for Phoenix. They win it 2-0. Mighty Ducks with a man advantage. Mironov leads it across. Here's Correa. Long pass to the point. Daniel to Mironov to Correa. He's back to the line. And in deeper, force deep. Ruchin. The point for Mironov. He led Anaheim in shots on goal in the first period. That one got through to the net. Ricocheted off Correa's stick. And cleared out. Oh, big hit. And Chuck leveled Ruchin. Look at Paul Correa, blister one over the top of the net. Broken stick right at the goalpost to the right of Javi Bullen. Mironov to Daniel, in deeper. Solani shot. Correa the rebound off the pipe. Oh! It down in front, and a sprawling, sprawling play by Johnson has driven it all the way down. This is Stanley Cup playoff hockey.
Hit after hit. Ruchin just gets crushed by Tkachuk. He gets up. Korea shot over the net.
Offside against the Mighty Ducks. 56 seconds left in their power play.
Jiggs, how do you get up after a hit like this? I mean, you're off balance. Tkachuk weighs about 220 pounds, 240 probably with equipment on. Boom, there's the play. This one went behind. Here comes Correa. Right there, Correa. Boom. Correa, watch him. He is so calm, so cool. He just goes to shovel it, hits off the side of the post, and then Correa introduces the first five or six rows of fans in behind the Phoenix net. Huh.
Hello, Kachuk. There's Paul Correa, Japanese descent. Looking forward to going back to Japan to represent Canada. His father, born in Canada, as was Paul, and went to the University of Maine. Black Bear.
The National Hockey League will start its season next year in Japan, as Anaheim and Vancouver will play the first two games of the year over there, sort of get everybody ready for the Olympics coming up.
That'll be fun. Mironov is back and chipped the puck deeper in his own zone. 34 seconds left in Dinnick's penalty time. Yari Curry, the seasoned and wily veteran, has lifted one high and deep in the zone for Salahi. In angle. Salati to Correa to the point for Mirna. To Correa. Find some opening. Foul! Look at the left pass. He's got the block back. Hobby Bullen at his best. And now Daniel rips one high and wide. Mirna, the defenseman in deep. Correa has picked up his block. Gave it to Correa. And Correa should say they score! 1-0 Mighty Ducks. Toward forcing game seven.
That was just a frenzy of activity by the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. Correa, now he's a left winger, but on the power play he's on that right side because his stick is at a better shooting angle when he gets that puck, and nobody has a quicker release than this kid. But you see Solani hustle over there. That's one of the reasons why they kept the puck in the zone. Great balance, great preparation again. He grabs a rebound, bounces it off the post. And for the second time in this series, Anaheim gets the first goal of this game. Good hustle by the Mighty Ducks. They move that puck around. Javi Bullen just, he can't be faulted. I mean, he made the first save, and then Correa picked up almost like a bouncing rebound and fires it home. Watch the puck come back out. Bouncing off the shin pad.
Fourth of this series for Paul Correa. Only 3 seconds remain on the penalty against Dinick. Power play is quick for the sixth time in the series. Mironov and Curry assisting on the goal. Scored at 6-12. That's Curry with a shot that didn't get to the net. Harper dropped it back. It bounces around in front. And comes all the way back to the point. Curry steps into one that is blocked. Was underneath his teammate. Oh, look at the puck go wide as Jansen tried the backhander. This is Greg Janney up to Kachuk. It's offside against Phoenix. Thirteen minutes, 8 seconds remaining in the second period.
And you look back in this Anaheim, you know, this was a real good next shift for Anaheim. They didn't come out and they were all jumping around, happy they scored that first goal. They drove towards net. They took it and just came right back at Phoenix. Now, Phoenix only has 9 shots on goal. Only one in the first 7 minutes of this period and not many late in the first period, Jakes. So Anaheim right now playing very, very well.
How about this for a stat? Anaheim getting the lead for the first time in the last 226 minutes in this playoff series. Winning the first period until 6-12 of the second period this afternoon. 226 minutes in which they had not led. All the rest of the time, either tied or trailing the Coyotes. Snoop puck in front. Oh, that close to being 2-0. Don Koharski, the referee this afternoon, has whistled the play dead. It is 1-0 Anaheim in the sixth game, only the second period.
You see, now this is where Anaheim needs that one extra guy to come up with a goal. Watch this play. Good execution by Anaheim. Curry in front. Ron Wilson talked about somebody else besides Curry Solani getting a goal. Curry had his chance right there.
Ellis had one in the first period. Albeit from long range, but still in this series, only Correa and Salati as forwards scoring for Anaheim. And look at the way they have dominated the prior shots on goal.
20-9, 9-1 in this period. But the crowd, Jake, surprised me, still very much into it. They haven't lost them yet in this building.
Yeah, no sag at all. Saw the scores. Detroit leading St. Louis in the third. 2-goal difference there. Still 2-2. Dallas and Edmonton. Nine. If Edmonton wins this afternoon, the Stars, who had a great, great regular season, are out. Edmonton, a very young but fast, quick hockey team with good goaltending. Motor on.
And big. If Edmonton wins, they'll automatically play Colorado next round.
Mm-hmm. Here the Ducks have one thing in mind, and that is to force game seven on their home ice Tuesday night. And they've taken the first step, as I said, 1-0, and a goal by Correa on the power play. concern Jeremy Roenick's condition. It's his knee, obviously.
Here's Roenick right here.
Oh, boy.
And if I'm not mistaken, isn't that the same knee, the left knee?
Yes, it is.
Is the one that Darrin Hatcher hit last season? So you know that it's already not going to be as strong, and he just gets crushed right here.
Oh, that left knee just caved knee to knee, one stationary, one moving. Nothing worse in this game.
Knee injuries are absolutely. Every player has red flags in those situations. Those are.
He and Ted Drury, knee to knee, and they continue to attend to Jeremy Roenick.
He plays with such abandon. Jiggs, he only knows how to play this way.
We'll be back to check on his condition, but first let's return to James Brown at our Fox Studios for this NHL game break.
All right, Jiggs and Peter, take a look at the St. Louis Blues having trouble clearing the puck. Detroit makes him pay. McCarty shot off there for the rebound and a follow. Kurt Muldy with his first career playoff goal, 3-1 Detroit. Let's take it back to Jiggs McDonald and Peter McNabb.
I knew they were called studios. I just wasn't sure JB was there. This is the scene live in Phoenix. They continue to attend to Jeremy Roenick. We'll be back.
Jeremy Roenick, one of the blood and guts players in this league. Nobody plays harder. Nobody plays with more passion. Nobody does it as hard as Jeremy Roenick. And once in a while, you're going to pay the price because of how you play the game. Watch Roenick pick the puck up, and he's trying to skate up to the middle. He lost it for a second, and Jiggs, he had to look down to find it. And when he looked down to find it, boom. That's when he ran into the Anaheim player.
It down, 1:36 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time. Jeremy Roenick gone, no doubt from the series.
This is where the Phoenix Coyotes have got to keep their composure. You lose your leader.
Now they kept the composure, and Drake blasted one right into the Mighty Duck logo. Somebody has to step forward now and pick up the role that Roenick has been filling. Who will it be on the Coyote bench?
You're talking just technically, strategy-wise, who is going to be the guy that's going to cover Korea? Because now Korea sees this. No one wants anybody hurt. But if Roenick's not going to be there, that is going to free up Korea to have a little more ice time. Someone's going to have to step up. On the other side, Roenick's a very big factor on the bench, in the dressing room, keeping the guys up. So somebody is going to have to pick it up for Phoenix right now.
Kachuk is in the middle here. Drake on the left, Janney on the right. Kachuk got the draw. Janney tipped it to Johnson, and his shot didn't get through. Here's Janney feeding it. Aronofsky fake, trying to step around the sprawling Jansons, and over they go to knock it loose and tear it out. This is going the length of the ice. Jim Johnson puts a stick on the puck. Face it off back in the Anaheim zone with 10 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the second period. Peter, I mentioned earlier this afternoon there's other playoff hockey going on. The Mighty Ducks farm team of Baltimore didn't qualify for the playoffs. They've got three players playing at Long Beach, California, in the International League, and they eliminated Milwaukee in straight games. On the Phoenix side of things, their team in the American Hockey League, Springfield, won last night 3-2 over Portland, and even their series at two games each. Springfield had a great year, finished first in their division, coached by Greg Gilbert. They did just a splendid job.
Greg Gilbert, coach of the year in the American Hockey League. Remember, the American Hockey League has fostered a lot of very good NHL coaches. Mark Crawford, former coach of the year in the American Hockey League.
High with a 1-0 lead. Quint for Phoenix has played it around the boards. Hello's waiting for it. Janney had him lined up, and the puck has popped loose at the center ice. Into the zone. Moore taking care of his guy. In time, Joe Sackle went back to the net, won the puck for Bello. Centers one across. That's Gallo. tackle on the end boards. Donnie Curry couldn't center. Didn't have anybody in front of the net anyway. Now he's got Bellows cruising around in front. No opportunity to get it out to him. Aaron Quinn for Phoenix reached in. Trying to get it to Kachuk. Up ahead on the play is Janney. On comes Drake. Janney waits, waits the late man with Quinn, and he couldn't take the pass. Now Dallas Drake fires and just missed the target. Abidalis off the board for that up. Trevor Nosky shot. Oh, just missed being tipped in by Janney. Bellows turned it over. Quinn does the same, and it's cleared out. All the way down. Trevor Nosky with time goes back. Anaheim changing up. Here's Trevor Nosky. On the right wing boards, he gave it to Cliff Rodding. Couldn't get it into the zone. Solani has room. Up comes Correa. Choked off on the play and taken down. There'll be a penalty. Mike Gartner is going to go to the penalty box once Phoenix controls the puck as they do now. Gartner complains. So does Chris King. Interference will be the call.
The first shift after Roenick isn't on the ice. With Correa, Gartner's forced to take a penalty. Now, Gartner is one of the fastest skaters that's ever played this game. But Correa now is just open just for a second. Gartner tries to pull him down. And to what Correa did right there, Sloan did a lot of things right to get that shot on net. Javi Bullen came up with the big save.
9 of the 21 shots the Ducks have had this afternoon have come on the power play, and you know who's going to be out there, don't you? There's Gartner in the box for interference. 38 years of age, been around the National Hockey League and put up some fantastic numbers.
But he's never won the big one, never won the Stanley Cup, and you know that is one thing that every player, the Ray Bourque has never won one. The great Hall of Fame players, that's the one thing that they, if they don't get it, there will be just a little something missing from their career.
Everybody wants to be known as a winner. Daniel Demirinov. Back to Daniel. Demirinov. On to Correa, tight on the boards. On to off the boards. Demirinov shot tipped. Daniel turns it around the near corner now for Correa. All Correa to Dmitry Demirinov. With Correa, DK works it across, but Drew Daniel is able to recover. Lanny works it in deeper. Mark out of this power play to Correa, to Miranov, to Daniel. Fires up the slot, under Javi Bullen, turn to take another look, but it's up against that right pad. No rebound on that shot.
Look at the power play for Anaheim. Now, Parks in front of the net. Rushin is not. Rushin went to the dressing room. You know, the only thing that we can remember is that unbelievable hard check he took from Kachuk. The last power play, the 1:08, but it got the goal on the rebound. The rebound shot of Correa.
And they used almost the entire 2 minutes to get it. Only 3 seconds left in Dinnick's penalty at that time. 8 minutes, 46 seconds left. Tim Army, Ron Wilson at the bench. Bellows on the draw. Stapleton pulled it back, and it's flipped high up into the air and into the sea of white. Right behind what is Phoenix players' bench. Well, this game has been interesting. Nothing, nothing at the end of one. 1-0 now. Paul Correa's goal. Jeremy Roenick gone with a lefty injury. And look at the shots on goal. Although, that hasn't worked in this series.
No, it hasn't. The five clubs that have outshot the other clubs have lost every time. But right there, Correa scores. The guys we highlighted have been big parts of this game. Correa gets the goal. Roenick injured. And you have to hope it's not as bad as it looks.
Miranov blasted one, and it came right back to him. Quarterback in this power play for the Mighty Ducks with a shot that was just wide. Nate Kachuk gathers it in. The right side, around the check of Miranov. There'll be a penalty on Miranov. A hooking signal from referee Koharski. 4-on-4 hockey coming up.
Miranov's a big man, 6'2", 215. Started the season with the Pittsburgh Penguins. When Pittsburgh was going badly, they made some changes. Miranov ended up with Anaheim, and he has been a very pleasant surprise But you get this penalty because you're strong. Tkachuk is just so powerful. It took Mironov. If Mironov's going against the normal player, he stops him right there. But he has to use so much to pull down Tkachuk. Tkachuk goes down, and now we're back to 4-on-4 hockey.
54 seconds left in the penalty to Gartner. There's the time of the penalty on Mironov. Phoenix hasn't been able to connect with the power play in recent games. We'll see what happens if and when they do get the man advantage. Well, they've beaten that duck. Yana has taken a pounding. Running on the draw, Drake was to his left. Phoenix. Aaron Quint played it around the boards. In after it is Moore, number six. Gets it on the end boards. Here's Dallas Drake. On to Clifani. Jabbed away, and Moore is pinched in from the point. Turned it over. And out they come. Sackle got it right back. Nice read on the play by Dallas. Sackle going, his head drove in, and it was going wide, but it was grabbed and held by Nikolai Habibula. 29 seconds remaining in the 4-on-4 situation. Don't go away.
Just look at the intensity. Watch the eyes of Marshall as he gets him in the sights right here. He's not getting out. Boom. And those are the kind of plays you have to make in your own defensive zone.
And hockey is a warm weather sport earlier this afternoon. Yep. A whiteout. Trying to get the Phoenix Coyotes back into this game. Tkachuk is out of the zone. Stumbled a little. Ruchin, who had gone to the dressing room, is back on the ice now for Anaheim. The Mighty Ducks up with the puck. Enyo overlaid Ruchin, however, and quickly Coyotes get back on it. Oleg Teperovsky down the left wing board. Tkachuk with him. There's Tkachuk's shot. High and wide. Held in by Cliff Ronning. Tkachuk goes back in the net. Daniel Ronning picks it up. Couldn't center it. Just as Tkachuk got away from his man. And here's Paul Kariya breaking the zone. Newman backing up on the play. Kariya with speed. Checked by Teperovsky. Kariya able to move the puck, but it went right to Teppo Newman. And now to Cliff Ronning. Power play opportunity here. Got shorthanded. Gartner's penalty had expired, but Diddick couldn't hold the puck at the line. Teperovsky hustles back. Tackles right on him. Well, tackle tied up Teperovsky. And he was there to handle the puck. He's number 15 with the lead pass. Too far for Gartner. And he touches up. Anaheim making contact first. That's icing against the Coyotes with 21 seconds left in their power play.
Well, as we expected, unfortunately for Phoenix, it's going to be an injury to the left knee of Jeremy Roenick. He will not play the rest of this game. They're going to have to obviously wait. You know, one of the keys is, look, you just have to look down for a second. He loses it. And then that's when Drury comes in. They went bang to bang. They will look at it again after the game and probably not make an assessment until tomorrow. The swelling's got to go down, and that's just tough. Roenick had started out slowly here in Phoenix. Really come on the last half. Excited this crowd. I mean, they're loving him the same way they did in Chicago when he played there. And for him to go down is a tough break personally and certainly for the Coyotes.
Now Phoenix running out the last few seconds in this power play. Aaron Quint through the middle. Fires one from center ice. Out of the air by Hebert. In came Stapleton, so Hebert wisely holds it for the faceoff. Francois Allaire, the goaltending coach acquired, or at least signed by Anaheim after his time had run out in Montreal. Allaire's the guy who worked with Patrick Waugh, and he has worked brilliantly with Hebert. Positioning. He was telling me last weekend when we were here, Peter, that concentration, having him know where he was in the net and being consistent game after game after game were the things that they worked on the most.
Yeah, they forced him to prepare early for shots. And one of the things what you do when you play like Patrick Roy, you don't move as much as other goaltenders. You're just in the right spot. So say it seemed less spectacular, but they're just as big.
You believe he's faced only two shots from the Coyotes in this period? This 10 on the afternoon?
Yeah, this has been a very dominant period for Anaheim.
That's the win on the road to prolong this series. 1-0, the power play goal by Paul Kirill. Now the team's back at full strength. At center, taken by Kevardoski to Quint. Quint backhanded it into the zone. Is back for Anaheim up to Timo Solani. Cleared it out, and it's taken here by Craig Janney. Back to Jim Johnson. Johnson originally signed to the NHL as a free agent. What a great career he's had. Yeah, there are a lot of players overlooked in the draft, eh? 24-10 are the shots on goal favoring the Mighty Ducks. Dallas. Solani flips it high in the air. Floating it down into the zone. Didn't go far enough, go fast enough for Isaac. So Dinnick is forced to move it. And here's Cliff Rodding starting out. Rodding overplayed it. Got it back and then couldn't get it to his teammate. And Shannon wide open for a moment. Now it blocked at the line and chipped in by the Mighty Ducks. Cliff Rodding has had a long shift here. Off the boards. Too far for Gartner, who's racing after it. There didn't get there in time. Long outlet finds Brian Bellows. Rodding was there to knock it away from him. Barkov works it across and got it right back and moves it on. Barkov across the line is pulled up. There's the long pass. Bellows gets to it. And it's through Curry, who's gone back to the net, as you saw. Temple Newman fails to get it out. Harper takes a big hit from King. Meantime, the play over on the far side. And Anaheim, very nonchalant. Little session there for the Coyotes. And here's Jari Kurri moving in. Kurri sets up the point man. Bad hit shot. Blocked. Loose puck. Oh, and it's covered. Bobby Bullen able to spot it just before Ted Jari. Bobby put it into a vacated net. Still 1-0 Mighty Ducks over the Coyotes. Late stages of the second period now. Now this crowd, the whiteout, little concerned, although they're still in the game. Their team is down 1-0. Anaheim very dominant, but here's Tkachuk breaking away. Got checked by Dallas, still got the shot off. Hebert the stop.
Jake, there's a great example of what you were talking about. Not as much movement, just being in the right spot. Hebert. As Tkachuk goes to the outside, Hebert just stays with him. Very little movement. Makes the save. Everything was in perfect spot. And Hebert is coming up with not a lot of saves, but he has been very sound, very solid. And sometimes it's tougher for a goaltender, believe it or not, to face only two, three, four shots in a period because all the actions at the other end, you're getting cold, and you know you're not necessarily as into the game as you might be if you're getting your 10, 12 shots.
Yeah, the concentration can disappear on you if you're left alone back there. Opportunity to take a seat, read the hockey news, whatever. Aaron Quinn fires one toward the net. Hebert has stayed sharp, hasn't he? You know, the big difference in this game is the way Phoenix has been dominated by Anaheim in the second period, especially an outshot. But the other thing of concern, of course, is the loss of Jeremy Roenick. And as Peter pointed out at the time, it's happened before. His left knee, and here's the videotape of that. Years ago.
Back in 95, you see that knee right there. Exactly the same knee. Very similar hit. Roenick goes down.
He and Hatcher in that collision with the Dallas Stars. Hatcher, of course. Look at the Coyotes bench. One of the major differences between Game 4 and Game 5. I thought in Game 5 and 6, let's correct that. Thought of the game at Anaheim the other night. Well, Anaheim had more shots on goal. They were coming from different area codes. From 213, 310, 562, 919, or 619. They weren't shooting from the 714 area code. Here today, they've been shooting from the 602 area codes. Utah, Nevada, 801, 702, things like that. Getting their shot from better range. Lottie choked off of the play by Dimmick. Now it's centered out in front. Aronoff able to complete the play. And a tip down, there'll be a penalty for the Mighty Ducks. Up come the Coyotes. Controlling the play here is Drake. The Chuck trying to drive to the net. Drake can't get enough time. But Browning steps into a shot that fluttered wide. He didn't keep her by Newman. Alice Drake checked, and as the Ducks took control, the whistle sounds. A roughing penalty coming up against Anaheim.
Well, behind the play, behind the net. Newman right there. Watch and see what happens as the play continues. Punches him in the side of the head. And again, the referee right there. You see the arm go up. Bang. Right there, it's going to happen. Punches him, and here comes Mr. Koharski. And bang, we are in power play time for Phoenix. And he, it was an Anaheim power play goal, and they've got to match it here now. So it's going to be a pretty tight dressing room if Phoenix goes into the third period down 1-0.
This will be their fourth power play of this afternoon's game. 15 consecutive power plays without a goal for the Coyotes.
Big guy in this situation, number 24, Mark Jansens for Anaheim. One of the best faceoff guys in the league.
And he is out against Rodding. He's in the middle. Gartner is on the left side. Drake on the right. Quentin Teberdoski at the point. That's Quint. Rodding with it now. That's not Quint. Rodding. Quint with a drive. It was blocked. Here's Rodding with it. 15 power plays without a goal. That one was blocked. Cleared around the boards. Teberdoski with Quint. Held it at the line. Now plays it deeper. Alice Drake. Got it. Teberdoski. It's shot. A low one was steered aside. Defense. That's Rodding. Losing around. Drops it back. Teberdoski. Fake. Held it and then sets up Rodding. Rodding shot. Didn't get to the net again. Daniel tied up with Gartner. Rodding was unable to pull out of the corner. Same story for Drake. Ducks have cleared it down the ice. Both teams changing up. Those numbers, 2-22.
They start to wear on your confidence. You start trying to force things instead of making it natural.
And just showing that, shooting it in. Being called on the play, which will bring the faceoff way, way out of the Anaheim zone, all the way back into the Phoenix end. 56 seconds in the power play. Well, the St. Louis Blues are finished. The Detroit Red Wings winning 3-1. The Red Wings advance under Scotty Bowman. 6 minutes to play in regulation time at Edmonton this afternoon. The Oilers and the Stars tie 2-2. And next Sunday, semifinals conference on the line. Check your local listing. We know it'll begin at 2 o'clock Eastern Time on Fox Sports.
We have 5 clubs now that have advanced. Colorado, Detroit in the West. Jersey, Philly, New York Rangers in the East. So no real major upset so far.
Stay tuned. Buffalo trailing Ottawa. They play tonight in Ottawa. Underway.
Buffalo the 2 seed in the East. Dallas the 2 seed in the West. Both in big trouble.
Here are the Mighty Ducks, who finished the season 2 points ahead of the Phoenix Coyotes, trying to force game 7 of this series. Leading 1-0. 36 seconds remaining in the penalty. Yes, Anaheim. Couldn't get Janney open. Here's Keith Kachuk. Couldn't hold it when he did. The whole top of the net taken away by Guy Hebert. It back to the line. Quint into Janney. Chuck trying to get open. Here's Quint at the point. Sets up Newman and then across to Janney, and he had to reach for the pass. And Janney took a pop from the back of the head, turned around. Harper wasn't looking at him. Another power play about to swept the side. 16 in a row without a power play goal. Aims at full strength to pop out in front of.
Gobert, the last 4 minutes, has made a couple of big saves. Credit the concentration. Credit Gobert with a very, very solid period. And again, the preparation before the shot. Watch Gobert in front. You see how square he is to the shooter. Goes down. Gets the glove up. But again, the preparation just perfect for Gobert.
What a huge catching glove. He's got half a cow in leather in that left hand.
Half a cow?
Yeah. You see the size of that trapper?
That's one big trapper. They've changed a little, haven't they, over the years, those gloves that the goaltenders have?
I'll say.
Of course, there's an awful lot of controversy earlier in the season about the size of goaltenders' equipment. The pads have now been made a standard size that could be no more than 12 inches across. They're just trying to stop the goaltenders from growing in the net. They're just getting bigger and bigger all the time.
1-0 Anaheim. A minute and 23 seconds remaining in the second period. We're in Phoenix this Sunday afternoon. Glad you're able to be with us. Ryan Bellows has played the puck in deep on behalf of the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. This game couldn't get it up the board. Here's Barinov from back of the net. Trying to get somebody open in front. Jansen's very briefly, and he was chopped down by Johnson. Barinov decides to do it himself. They score! The Ducks are up 2-0.
That extra guy, Ron Wilson talked about that extra guy. Somebody coming up with that goal. And if Brian Bellows in close, Jiggs, we talked about it. That's where Bellows is so good. Way over 400 goals in this league. Good goal scorer, 450 goal scorer. And Mironov, the defenseman. It's a little bit risky being the defenseman down low, but you know, he had control of the puck. He was walking out front, and Bellows just was able to get himself free. You watch all the Phoenix players, they're looking at the puck. In comes Bellows. He was free. Bobby Bullen could not find it through the pack. And here's the reaction on Anaheim's bench as they know they have got firm control of this hockey game.
Ryan Bellows with his 24th Stanley Cup playoff goal. Here's Savani with a shot. Oh, Bobby Bullen looked over his shoulder. How many times has he done that this afternoon?
They're saying it was in. Now remember, this will be under review. This will be under review. If it's in, it will count.
Absolutely. Vermont had a video review this afternoon. Two goals scored. That may be a new Stanley Cup record for 97.
And one thing about it is, you know, upstairs they've already looked at it, and they know whether or not it was a goal.
Headline on the paper in Vancouver the other day. He shoots, he scores, subject to review. Numanen rounds the net and starts out. 7 seconds, all that's left in the period. And with Anaheim scoring in the last minute of period two, they'll go to the dressing room leading 2 or maybe 3-0.
And Jake, you know what's going to happen? They're going to review this. If it's in, we go back and play another 55 seconds. They go back to when it was scored.
Now keep in mind, no player or coach can ask the referee. The referee and the linesman consult. And while the referee may give you the signal that the puck has entered the net, that no longer means the goal is good. So Don Koharski has gone to the video review booth to check this one.
Here it is. Now watch. It's go through the legs. Solani's shot goes through the legs. Does a defenseman pick it up after it's gone over the goal line?
Oh, boy. Oh,
I can't tell. That was so close. I would say from that angle, no, it wasn't a goal. But they do have the angle from above, and this is going to be so close.
They have gone to the video review, as you see.
The entire puck has to be completely over the goal line. Yeah, and it looks to me, Jiggs, the only one that's going to tell you is that one from right above, looking down. Here we cannot, you just can't tell if he hoods it after it's just over by a fraction. There goes the shot. Now Solani, it goes through the legs of Bobby Bullen, and you see it's coming through, right there, ooh, through there, it's right there. Is it over? Rocket back. There's the line right there, but it's going to be tough to tell from this angle. Jiggs, what do you think? I think it's from that one, when they slowed it right down, it looked like it was in.
It looked like it had just crawled across, giving new meaning to the term close. Close only counting in horseshoes, grenades, dancing, and now hockey. Well, all Korea, the captain of the Ducks, Pete Tkachuk, the captain of the Coyotes, referee number 12, Don Koharski. Called it with the
linesman.
No goal. No goal is the signal. Ron Wilson's team, though, has a 2-0 lead, and Correa now with an opportunity to question the referee and what he saw when they saw upstairs. 2-0, Ducks. We'll send it back to JP and Dave for the new Dodge Intervention Report after these words.
Mission Report here at the Fox Television Center. James Brown along with Dave Maloney. In the game you're watching, Phoenix not only trailing by two, but Jeremy Roenick left the ice, helped off the ice. Pretty serious looking knee injury.
Anaheim has been the better team, JB. How do you stop Brett Hull? First and goal right there, Konstantinov on St. Louis's best player, Brett Hull. This is the second period on the power play. Sandstrom to Shanahan, 2-1 Detroit in the second period. Biggest play of the second period of the game, Turgeon's left skate in the crease before the puck was in the crease. As Hull gets it explained to him, it's not going to work, Brett. Doesn't work. But in the third period, McCarty to the net, Maltby to the net. That's it, 3-1. And boys, that's all she wrote for St. Louis. This series turned when Detroit was able to wear down the St. Louis defense. Not enough offense from St. Louis's Turgeon, Hull, and Fuhrer. Good series. Let's go up to Edmonton in the first period here. This is Leighton, top shelf first period. Puts Dallas on the board in the first period. Again, this is Big Mike Greer going to the net after Bookberger finds him. Second period, Verbeek's going to find Bassin in front. That's a 2-1 Dallas lead. Late off the faceoff, Lindgren finds Tchaikovsky, scored 2-2 after two. Now, Mike Modano's going to do a great job getting his fourth. Throws it to the net. It is late in the third period. Dallas celebrating. They may get a chance to wrap it up in Game 7 at home.
Only a minute left in that one, and whenever Mike Modano scores a goal, Dallas is 25-5-4. When we come back, Dave Maloney and I will talk about the controversy taking place up in Buffalo involving their outstanding goalie, Dominic Hasek. Stanley Cup action continues tonight on ESPN2 as Eastern Conference upstarts Buffalo and Ottawa meet in Game 6 of their quarterfinal series. Airtime 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific. And we welcome you back to the new Dodge Intermission Report. I'm James Brown along with my partner, Dave Maloney. All right, folks, time now to get you caught up on what's happening around the NHL, and that Buffalo-Ottawa game could send the Sabres to the golf course. Now, normally that would be the big story, but not in Buffalo. Instead, it's whether goaltender Dominic Hasek is healthy. Last Monday, Hasek, who some believe was the NHL's most valuable player this past season, hurt his right knee on this play. And you'll get a chance to take a look at it again to see how he did stretch that knee. That injury forced him to leave the game. He then watched the rest of the game by standing behind the bench. Well, the next day, Buffalo News columnist Jim Kelly suggested Hasek wasn't that hurt, and Dave instead quit on his teammates. Well, that led to an ugly confrontation after Game 5, allegedly involving Hasek spitting at Kelly's feet and calling him the worst person in the world. What is going on?
Well, to me, JB, the issue is why now? Dominic Hasek has every right to defend the honor of competing as a professional. Now, could he have done it without spitting at the feet of a local reporter? Most certainly. The reporter, Jim Kelly, whom I happen to get to know and respect when I played in Buffalo, has been around the game long enough to know the nuances of this sport. If anything, Kelly is guilty of bad timing. Now, as a reporter, he did his job and reported. Let's not kill the messenger. The issue of whether Hasek bailed out on his team is something only he can answer. But if this whole affair represents a power struggle between the coach and general manager, take it up after the season's over, which may very well happen sooner than later if the Sabres don't get their act in gear and win the next two games.
What's this power struggle you're referencing?
Well, all year long, GM John Muckler and coach Ted Nolan have apparently had this feud underneath. It has essentially to do with whether Nolan should get a further contract extension. I think it's ludicrous to think that Hasek is playing that scene out by whether he plays or not. Get it over with later,
The Sabres don't have time to worry about this now.
And Dave, you know, if Ottawa wins, that sets up a great second round matchup between the New York Rangers and, of course, the Philadelphia Flyers. The old legs of New York came through in that series, but what kind of intriguing matchups would you be looking at?
Well, I think the most intriguing matchup may be the result of what the Rangers did at the end of February, getting Esa-Tiikkanen back from the Vancouver Canucks. The Rangers did not have that pest influence that they had when they won the Cup, when they had Tiikkanen. Where does this play out against the big guy, Erik Lindros? I think it would be an awful lot of fun to watch Tiikkanen get inside of Lindros's head and play around for a while.
I like that expression, pest influence. All right, folks, and speaking of the next round, we'll be back next Sunday with the conference semifinals. For the game and time in your area, check your local listings. And a reminder that for all the latest information on the coolest game on earth, visit www.nhl.com, brought to you by IBM and the NHL. The quest for the Cup returns on Fox after this.
Welcome back to Phoenix. The Mighty Ducks of Anaheim leading two to nothing and trying to tie the series of three games each. These statistics are brought to you by Bud Ice.
And again, we go to scoring. The shots on period in that second period. The Anaheim Mighty just took over. Scoring chances now 11-6 in favor of the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. 9-4 in that second period as they were just dominant.
We wait until the second period for the opening goal of the game, and guess who got it? Paul Kariya.
Well, Kariya with a patented goal by Kariya. Tough shot, tough angle, just great concentration as he gave them the 1-0 lead. And then the one that may have turned this whole series, Jeremy Roenick, right here. His left knee, boom. Hopefully it's not as bad as it looks right there. And then Bellows, that all-important second goal from somebody besides Timo Solani or Paul Kariya, and Bellows, 2-0 lead. And Guy Hebert has been perfect in goal so far in today's game. 14-14 as Tkachuk is robbed late in the period.
Is it 2-0 or is it 3-0? It is 2 officially. Anaheim, 2 second period goals. Guy Hebert, 14 saves. A penny for the thoughts of Don Hay. I said 3. Well, let's take a look from overhead. Was this in? Solani on the rush.
Here's the shot right here. Now watch the puck rolling across. Man, stick right there. That's as absolutely as close as it can possibly be. Back and forth.
And me being that the entire puck must cross the line. Well, to this point, a great day for Southern California. The Lakers win, and they're up 2-0 in their series, and the Mighty Ducks are up 2-0 in this game and trying to force Game 7 at the pond. Great day for Southern California to this day. But it's a 60-minute game here, and we'll see what happens. Nate Tkachuk has had 5 shots on goal for the Coyotes. Paul Kariya's had 5. Timo Solani's had 4. Dmitry Mironov with a half dozen shots. 27-14, the shots on goal. Neighbor of the Ducks, they haven't quacked.
You know, Jigs, usually if you're up 2-0, other team's building in a game six like this, your goaltender's absolutely stood on his hands, and you've taken advantage of a couple of your scoring chances. But in this game, the Mighty Ducks have been the better club so far. So Phoenix has got to come and change that momentum, get things going their way a little bit. They need something early.
Of course, Heath Tkachuk to the far boards. Great, read the puck for Tkachuk. Nice pass to Quarkin, but he had nowhere to go. Dave Ruchin didn't get it out of the zone. Newman another shot. Up high. And there, shot all the way. The net came off after the whistle. A little pushing and shoving. 35 seconds into the third period. I'm Jigs McDonald with Peter McNabb. Jeppo Newman has been some story. This whiteout. You know the history of the whiteout, don't you, Peter? How it began in Winnipeg?
The folklore?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's... Tell the story. That's unbelievable.
Oh, well, it's your story. I wouldn't go there.
The pig farmer who didn't make it to the first playoff game.
Yeah.
His buddies. His car broke down. He was walking. He froze to death. His buddies knew that he would be there. They went and found him, brought him, and sat him down in the seat in his white parka. No, don't believe it. That's not how it happened. That's all these... That's...
I had just about
I followed the whole story.
I was thinking, gee, this is a great story.
It's intriguing anyway.
Two to nothing, Mighty Ducks. There are the dark uniforms, the Coyotes in their home white. And the white out, the sea of white. Well, over 16,000 seats in this arena. Battle here, won by Anaheim. Correa away with the puck. And turned it over, and Mike Gartner for Phoenix. Got it into the zone, and Tarpa gets it out. Jari Kurri freed it, and turned it over. Gartner checked as he got to the blue line. That's Dmitry Mironov shooting it down the ice. Both teams changing up at the respective players' benches, as you see. From back of the net and turning with it. Oh, Jay Moore. Oh, hello. He's sorted things out. And able to make the player change. And Mike Stapleton using the board. Got it to the line and no further. Aaron Van Imp has set up the last two games. John Jury moving up. He got turned around. There's Keith Tkachuk handling it. And off the stage by Jury's check. By a power play chance. Michael. Drew Jury as it turns out. Coyotes trying to get out of the zone. But unable to complete the first pass. You're not going to go anywhere when you do that.
Yeah, right now just banging it out of their zone, trying to stave off any pressure from Anaheim, who's now making 20-25 second shifts, getting off and on the ice in a real smart fashion.
Old Mo, momentum didn't show up Phoenix this afternoon. He was here last Sunday, again Tuesday, and he went to Anaheim for Thursday with them, but he's not here. If he is here, he's changed dressing room.
Missed the charter.
Yes. To take over again at center ice and drive it in deep around the board. Picked up by Gerald Dinnick. Handed it into the zone. You see all five Ducks in formation, stretched out of the line. Nice shot. There's Mironov up around the board. Too far for Bellows, however. This game played it to the side of the net. Came right back. Orton can't move it in time. Then Ducks get it to Numinen, and his shot knocked down well out in front. Mironov slides into the boards, covering a loose puck. He had broken a stick earlier anyway. It is 2-0 Anaheim in Game 6.
Detroit finishes off St. Louis 4-2. Dallas comes back on a late Mike Modano goal to send it back to Dallas, tied at 3. Now, as we look at the brackets, Chicago is gone. St. Louis is gone. We've got Game 7s, Dallas, Edmonton. And right here, we're sitting looking at a potential Game 7 in this series as Anaheim right now ahead 2-0.
And the other thing on the horizon would be shutout number 12. And this is the 44th playoff game, the opening round, the quarterfinals. Record for most shutouts in one playoff year, 16. But three seasons ago.
What's interesting, two other games have been nothing into overtime, eventually 1-0 victory. So we've already had 13 games that have at the 60-minute mark have had shutouts.
It's Cliff Ronning with a shot to drop. Up around the boards and is cleared out of there. Warren Reichel has shot it too far too quickly. As it turns out, it's an icing call against the Mighty Ducks. Here's the story on shutouts.
That's a record for the first round of the playoffs. 11 already. And the year of the goaltender continues into the playoffs. And you could only expect it to be that way with the kind of years that some of the goaltenders have had around the league. Hubert, Abbey Boulin, great seasons. I mean, Waugh, Brodeur, obviously Hasek. What a controversy around Hasek, Jake.
Yeah, he got into it with the writer, Jim Kelly, a very well-known and prominent writer and well-respected writer in Buffalo.
Not the youngest guy in the world. I mean, you know, see, which one, you know, Hasek was taking exception to an article written about him not being as injured as he was saying. And really gotten ugly, that whole thing with Buffalo. And they don't need the distractions. They're down 3-2 in that series.
Oh, true. Yeah, how the game has changed. Conversation yesterday with Keith Tkachuk, who got married, by the way, during the season. I said, you know, with old-time hockey, Keith, that if you got married during the season,
subject to being sent down to the minors and maybe never resurface. Well, Jim Lack in Toronto is famous for that. Long shot. Grabbed and held there. Jeremy Roenick injured in the second period this afternoon. Knee-on-knee collision just past the eight-minute mark. He and Drury. Left knee against left knee, and Roenick was helped to the dressing room. Here it is again.
And you look at Roenick, he just missed the pass a little bit from there. He wasn't quite in control of the puck. Looked down like it looked like he looked down for a second, and that's when the Anaheim player came across.
Our last report from the Phoenix dressing room, he is still here, has not been taken to the hospital. As you pointed out so correctly, they have to wait for the swelling to subside, and that won't be until tomorrow, if then. Look out, that knee is iced. White Tracy has gone to the dressing room, you understand? With JR. Just to clean up the Kachuk story, just since the game is different now. And of course, when he's got 52 goals in the season, your player can do whatever he wants.
Well, they're not sending me anywhere when you score 52 goals.
Oh, well, it would have been closer to home, Springfield Mass, but of course, Kachuk having grown up in Boston. Interesting, too, that his dad is a firefighter. And Danny is playing for here as the coach, John Hayes. Firefighter in Canada, Kamloops, British Columbia. They don't talk about firefighting. They just want to set some fire here now and get this Coyote Club going again. They're down 2-0. We've played the first 5 minutes of the third period.
First, you know, Ron Wilson talked about the first 5 minutes of the game, but the first 5 minutes of each of the periods, first, second, and third, Anaheim has come out and played well. Not really allowed this place to go crazy, because it wants to. This place wants to go nuts and make it deafening in here, but Anaheim is doing just a perfect job of keeping everybody at least semi-conscious.
Well, as they pointed out around the dressing room this morning, Anaheim, they played desperate hockey. They had to, because on New Year's Day, they were 7 points behind Phoenix. They finished up 2 points ahead of them, but to make the playoffs, assure themselves of home ice advantage. If they get game seven of this series, that's what home ice is all about. They played desperate, but had not in the last three games. Far today, leading 2-0. Larkner in after a loose puck. Abidalas beat him to it, and Skies went out to center ice. Jim Johnson, Dwoleg Teberdoski, and Drury right on him, and spun away from the check. Now it's Johnson with a pass into the middle for Ronning. Looked up and there was a guy in a black uniform right there. Jansen. And it got the puck out of the zone. It came back to Dallas. Didn't get it out. Here's Ronning with a shot. That changed direction. Larkner turns, fires off the stick. Ronning unable to control it. Teberdoski keeps it in the zone. And couldn't get it to Larkner cleanly. Out of center ice, Teberdoski was knocked down. That's nowhere near where the play is. Crowd trying to get the referee's attention. Doesn't matter. Teberdoski on cross-ice pass. Cleared right back by Van Emp. That's Janney working the boards. McCurry using the half boards. Cut it off and shot one into the far corner. There goes Jim Johnson. And he got it out. Anaheim dominating the third period again. Firing it hard around the board. Came outside the line and now shot back in. Time for an update back to James Brown in our Fox Television Center.
Jigs and Peter, here is the game winner in the Dallas contest. Mike Madonnell, the man doing the honors. When McDonald scores a goal, Dallas is 25-5-4. It's now going to be a game seven in Dallas. Take it back to Jigs McDonnell and Peter McNabb.
All the way from Edmonton, you can hear that sigh of relief. Ken Hitchcock and his coaching staff with the Dallas Stars.
Never ceases to amaze me. People always talk about the fact that you have to have these guys come up with games, your role players, and they do. But at key moments, it's usually the stars that come out and make the plays, because that's why they're the stars. And Madonna gets the big goal in that series.
Usually in a Hollywood production by the Disney people, there's a happy ending. In here, having to turn this series around after losing the momentum in the comeback today. The Mighty Ducks, owned by the Disney Corporation, took to handle the
puck and the play called. It is 2-0. The Mighty Ducks of Anaheim leading the Phoenix Coyotes. There's the story. Correa and Solani until today, and after a 1-0 lead even, have been the only forwards to score for Anaheim. Ryan Bellows at 19:01. 3-2, and it's still 2-0 Anaheim as the play is back in their zone. The puck came out in front, cleared aside, and now shot out of the zone high and hard and all the way down for an icing call. Anaheim sitting on a 2-0 lead, intent to ice the puck. This telecast is presented by authority of the National Hockey League and is intended for the private use of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this telecast, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the telecast without the express written consent of the National Hockey League, is prohibited. Looking ahead, 12.5 minutes remaining approximately in regulation time. At the conclusion of today's game, Peter and I have the task of selecting the chief player of the game. A lot of candidates at this point. On the draw, Tavernoski. One wide. Knocked it away. Handled here by Jensens, who has had a strong game. He just tipped it down the ice. Far enough for icing this time. Johnson went back. It's another pick for Tavernoski. Stapleton gets back to the net and picks up the puck. Stapleton. On pass. Kachuk moving down the right side. Jansen's got just enough of them. Again, the crowd screaming for the penalty. Time to be called. Came out in front. Stapleton, one whack, and then immediately four Ducks surrounded him.
The Ducks are really collapsing down low. There's three forwards down there, and there's five Anaheim Mighty Ducks down there trying to strip the puck away. They're giving away a little bit of a point shot to take away any action in front of the Bear.
Another call. This one will go against Phoenix. Stopping the clock with 11.5 minutes to play. Regulation time.
Kachuk, who is so big and strong. Now, normally a left winger on the right side, he cuts towards the middle. And you're right about Jensen. He's a big guy. And he's going to take an awful lot of the draws as we get down to this end of this game. Because Anaheim, any doubt, they're just dumping the puck out of the zone. They'll take icings.
They're a well-coached squad, as is Phoenix. Protecting the lead. The team in only its fourth season in the National Hockey League. Look out here. Curry's line with a blocking glove save. Moore moves it around to the far side of the ice. And up they come. Coyotes come to center ice. Turn quick. Depositing it deep to the Anaheim zone. And all three forwards in deep. Here's Shannon. Put it out in front. Robbing is forced to the backhand. There's Shannon as he cuts through. And scores!
Teams don't die in playoffs easily, do they, Jake?
No, sir.
You know, a lot of times during the regular season, a game like this that Anaheim is playing may be enough to keep a team down. But Phoenix is fighting back. They're trying everything. And Shannon, who was the star of Game 3 and really helped turn this series around for the Phoenix Coyotes, scored the first two goals of the series of that game, Game 3, scores the first one tonight, and suddenly it's a one-goal hockey game.
It'll be Shannon from Ronning and Gartner at the 8-minute mark. There's still a long way to go, but you can't tie it and win it without getting the first one. Brown is still standing. A whiteout. Taking over again. Appleton playing it back deep in his own zone. There's Teppo Numminen. Luchinen to forecheck. So is Correa. And Numminen got it to center ice. Bobby Dahlis is back and has given it to J.J. Daniel. Back to Dahlis. Off his skates. Now to Daniel. Appleton on the forecheck roll. Looks content to clear it out. Numminen sets up at center. Airs it hard around the boards. Getting it well away from Hebert. And right to Kemo Talati. Correa coming with him. Talati, big. Headed across to Correa. Johnson battling away, trying to pin Correa in the pot. Stapleton freed it up. Here's Teberdoski. Oh, down goes Correa. Johnson has just now released him and recovers the puck. He lost his helmet, as you see. Jimmy Johnson hearing it from the crowd. Well, they like that, don't they? Jansen's has played it in deep. There's Johnson, who met by Reichel in a big hit. Bobby Bullen played it to the left side. Up comes Tkachuk. Nice pass. Alice Drake checked at the blue line. Reichel cleared it back to center. Janney was waiting there. This is Drake. Pass handled by Janney to Tkachuk. Trying to put a move on Dmitry Mironov. Tkachuk unable to get it to his man at the point. Jury unable to get through center ice for Anaheim. Now Jury recovers again. Jansen's was taken down. No whistle. Abor back to play the pass here onto the stick of Drake. Off the boards and in deep. What a difference a goal makes. This crowd really excited. Big hit back to the play. The puck is popped loose and Quint goes back for it. And that's an icing call against the Mighty Ducks. Just under 9 minutes to play in the third period of Phoenix.
The later you get into the game, the more the little battles are fought and won, and they'll make the difference. Koharski right there, watching everything. What comes into the play, watch Don Koharski, one of the best referees in the game. The left side of your screen, you see Koharski come in, he watched the whole thing. Koho is not going to call any Mickey Mouse stuff right now. It's going to have to be something tough to be called. Because Koharski, he lets them play.
I love it.
Oh, me too. Here's Paul Correa breaking out. Solani with him on the far side. They got Dinnick turned around. Correa shot. Blocked. Big rebound. But Stapleton was there. Mike Stapleton over center. A pass on to Tkachuk. Winds up and fired it high. Stapleton to Dallas. Great. Great. Turned it over. Paul Correa's cleared the zone. And Teppo Nimina takes over at center ice. Luminen off the boards with a shoot-in. We have played nearly 12 minutes of the third period. Just four shots on goal. One of them went in. That was Shannon's shot. Making it a 2-1 hockey game. Archer knocked off his skates. Crowd unhappy again. Good thing there wasn't whistle giveaway day here for this crowd. Think the referees. Teberdoski is back. Shannon turned it over. Mironov hammers that deep into the zone. Back on it is Jim Johnson. The forecheck thrown up by Anaheim, but then the puck came loose and Teberdoski comes to center ice. Archer with him. Teberdoski trying to weave through that crowd. Mironov got a chunk of him. Puck cleared out to center. Chris King nearly turned it over. And the second pass went through Cliff Rodding. Anaheim has forced Coyotes back. That's Reichel with a long shot that was wide. Trying to get something going again. Bob Corkum starting the play, and Gartner has shot it in. Offside is called. Corkum with lots of speed got in ahead of the puck. 7 minutes and 1 second left. Regulation time.
Here's Gartner breaking up the boards. And again, trying to play the puck. Gartner, stick gets tangled. They're not going to make calls. They've been referees been told not to make calls away from the play. Right there again, both pucks. Back-to-back, 8-penalty-minute games. Very disciplined hockey.
I'll say it is. Well, it's all about it. Road to the Stanley Cup. Quest that began 10 days ago now. Ray back in the puck in deep. Bobby Bullen left it there. Quint chips it up ahead. Got it out of the zone. Bobby Dallas for Anaheim. Curry and Jansen's up front. He's fair and quick. Out of the far side. King decided to take the hit, let the puck go loose, and then it came back to him. He's moved it on. Into center ice, Shane Doan. Doan is on a roll. There's in the corner. There's Daniel. Curry, oh, he's met by Giddick, who came in quickly. Coyotes pounce on a loose puck. Chris King turned it over, and Curry has dumped it out to center ice. So Numanen from there to Giddick, who missed the pass. And tries to drive in around Bellows, or Dallas, excuse me. He plunked Dallas on the helmet with a stick, albeit accidental. It seems the call against Anaheim, under 6 minutes to play in regulation. Since 1987. 42 of the Game 7 series, the home team with a huge advantage. That's what home ice advantage is all about.
Anaheim obviously wanted to take it back, as Dallas has. Big win for Dallas. What a character effort that was after an unbelievable loss at home. Double overtime, they lose 1-0. They have to go in, but Dallas is a very good road team. Maybe the best in the league. They have a system that works perfectly. And Madonna came up with a big effort.
Yeah, they sure have. Anaheim on the road with an outstanding effort today. Long shot there. That close. Ducks able to clear it out. All Korea. Kamel Salania. And he backhanded it in. Kotruchin inside the blue line. And now the offside is being called. And Salania went right back in. Well, tonight, you won't want to miss the fast-paced action of the all-new special on the world's scariest police chases, 2, followed by all-new episodes of The Simpsons, King of the Hill, and The X-Files. It's all part of the best night on TV, Fox, Sunday night, tonight at 7, 6 Central Time, here on Fox.
I think I missed Police Chases 1.
Yeah.
You see the faces, they're getting a little nervous. Getting a little bit nervous, everybody, as we're getting down to that 5-minute mark in this game. 5 minutes remaining in this game.
Phoenix has not tested Guy Bear, not had a shot on goal since that goal went in. Jansen's trying to set something up. Stapleton's shot was blocked. Who's getting it, feeding the point? Numanen lets it fly. That didn't get to the net, and up comes Korea. 3-on-2. Rutschen handling it here on the left side. Make the pass. With it again into Salani, had to reach for it. And the Salani taken down, the puck underneath him, and the clock stopped with 5:07 left. This is one of the funniest guys in the league, Kamel Salani. When you get talking to him, tells great stories. 3 of his buddies in Finland, including 2 of his buddies and himself, all got married last summer. The bachelor parties are a little different over there. Kamel's date, they took him out and had a tattoo put on his right leg that says Finnish flag. Well, his good friend and the captain of the Jokerit team was next. So what do? They put him in a goalie mask and goalie equipment, put him in a little boat just outside Helsinki, about 30 feet offshore, and sold eggs to anyone who wanted them. 50 cents a piece to fire eggs at this guy.
The question is, what did Bachelor number 3 get?
What?
Is that the X factor that we can't get into?
It's possible.
We got the tattoo. We got the flying fish eggs. Somebody's going to have to be pretty creative.
Walter Nolmanen is his buddy that shot or threw the eggs at. Captain of the Opera team in Finland. Now they do it differently.
Puck dumped in. Under 5 minutes to go. The puck behind the Anaheim net. And quickly the Coyotes on a Tarkovsky shot. Blocked in front. And another pin. Yari Curry brings it out. Curry putting it deep into the zone where Johnson took it out of the air. Gets it on the stick now. The round of Tarkovsky. All that Tarkovsky. Too far from the shot that was coming back. Anaheim. To show the world here on Fox how to go about protecting the lead and finishing off a game on the road. They learned their lessons well. That's what the next 4 minutes and 6 seconds will tell us. All that's left in regulation time, a 2-1 game, Anaheim in front. Kachuk knocked down heavily. And he has iced the puck, as it turns out. And seeing the linesman's arm up under it, be a penalty call.
hitting in playoff takes us to Tkachuk. Just doesn't see Reichel till the last second, and it was one of those ones, Jake, when it first happened, I went, oh, is he hurt? He was just down trying to make a point to the referee. Reichel steps into him, Tkachuk ices the puck, and now we've crept through another minute of this game, and we're down to under 4 minutes. Things get a little tighter again.
On the draw here, Phoenix up with it, a long pass to Tkachuk, trying to get around the check, that's good. A penalty being called against the Mighty Ducks. Harpa can't believe it.
Effort, effort, more effort from Keith Tkachuk. He just kept riding up the ice. Somebody for Anaheim's got to get Karpa off. Karpa, who's played along with all the Duck defensemen, a solid game, does not need to drop his conduct right now. Here's a penalty.
However, I repeat, keep in mind, Phoenix hasn't been able to cash in a power play chance since game two of this series.
And if there is one plus in all of this, it's for the next 2 minutes, Anaheim can just dump the puck out of the zone all the way down, and it will not be taken back into their zone for an icing call.
Coyotes 0 for 4 on the power play this afternoon, 0 for the last 16. There's the captain, Keith Tkachuk. You heard him say he wants to be known as a winner. Not just the guy who won the scoring, at least led the league in goals scored one season.
It's amazing, isn't it? That's what all the players want. They'll give up individual things. That's the wonderful thing about hockey players. The individual things go right out the window.
They won the draw. Tabernacki works it across. Good shot. Good pad save by Hebert. Chuck brings it up. Ronning sets up Newman. If Ronning sneaks in along the half board, drops it back. Newman with it here. Into Ronning. Back it goes. Newman into Tabernacki for the shot. That changed direction, and quickly a bear dives on a loose puck. One stop, 3 minutes, 28 seconds in regulation time. A minute 39 left in the power play for Phoenix.
With Roenick out of the lineup. A lot of times he likes to have a puck on the board. It's going to go with the little Cliff Ronning, and he does a nice job of setting up the shot. Ronnie, a very clever guy with the puck. Here's the initial shot on goal. Tkachuk, the power and the work again in the corner. And here's where Tkachuk goes. Makes it so hard for the defense. He's got great balance. Daniel just keeping contact, trying to keep him aware that he's at least there.
Quite a delay here before putting the puck back on the ice. Oh, my, Tabernacki bought some time. He went over, tried two different sticks, supposedly got a new one. I'm positive he's back with the stick he had to begin with. And referee Koharski went over and talked to them. Tkachuk on the draw with Jansen. And now, Mironov spins it out of there. Here's Ronning back at his own end of the ice. Tabernacki with it now. Now they beat it. Cross ice to Gartner, hard in around the board. Mironov waited patiently and cleared it all the way down. Exactly 3 minutes in regulation time. Phoenix down by a goal. If they don't get one to tie it and perhaps send it to overtime, they go back to Anaheim. Curry, good checking job, and that's Timo Solani shooting it down the ice. 50 seconds left of the power play. That's aluminum. Didn't get the pass to Stapleton cleanly. That gave Dallas a chance to clear it. Up comes Solani, forcing it outside the line. And he waits to get the play back onside. Across the line now, that's Darren Quick controlling the puck. Couldn't get it to the net. Danny on the end board, set it, Tkachuk, the money score!
they all got in, but they all got down low. You saw the four Anaheim players, they were all there, but they were all real deep. And now Tkachuk in front all by himself. Perfect shot along the ice. Took his time. He hasn't gotten open for clean shots like that very often, but he took advantage of it.
You don't need us to tell you what happened. Look at the bench. Listen to the crowd. Is due here in the Valley of the Sun. The Phoenix Roadrunners have been here for many, many years. But this is the National Hockey League. This is the Stanley Cup playoff time of the year. And there is Keith Tkachuk, who is tied at a 2-2.
And now you think back to the end of the second period when you watch this. Watch this shot. As it rolls and rolls.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Is that close or what?
Another storyline unfolding. We haven't been allowed to see the overhead shot. And one would begin to wonder why now, as we have throughout this period, Peter and I. It happened so quickly after the Bellows goal to make it 2-0. We were in replays and apologized not having it. And the overhead cameras that are installed in all 26 NHL arenas, what they saw, what picture they had, unavailable to us until the game was over. The announcement on the goal has brought the crowd to a standing ovation again. In time, the Mighty Ducks hammering away in the Phoenix end of the ice and turn it over. Alice Drake feeds it up ahead. This is Shannon. Drops it back. Markham punches on the end board. Shannon with it again. Spins it out in front, but the crowd was set up in front of the Bear. See how the Mighty Ducks handle it now after protecting the lead so well until 17:44. Janney and Quint assisting on Tkachuk's goal to tie it. 2-2, a minute and 24 seconds left in the third period. Ducks played it into the Phoenix zone. They move it out of there. Here's Gartner with a break. Fires and hits his own rebound. Murray spins it up and off the boards. All the way down. That'll stop the clock. Big faceoff coming in the Anaheim end with a minute and 5 seconds in regulation.
Gartner with that great speed almost gets open, but you see on the right side, defenseman just comes across a little bit just to throw him off, but Hebert was out. And you know, with each time somebody has a chance, there's Gartner. Players moving up to see what's going to happen.
First period was scoreless. Maria scored on a power play goal at 6:12 of the second period. Bellows in the last minute of the second period. Shannon at 8 minutes of the third period. And don't you know, Keith Tkachuk will get the second goal for Phoenix. Janney and Quint assisting at 17:44. The whiteout. Unbelievable. The crowd into it. 52 seconds from overtime in game 6. Icing will be the call against the Mighty Ducks. A no-no.
It's so interesting to watch a team when they shut things down offensively, Jigs. You shut it down offensively, you start to concentrate on your defensive part of the game. And you know, you start not thinking, and it's hard to turn it back on.
Yeah.
Look at this interesting number. Usually it's about 50-50. There have been 7 overtimes this year. The home club has won 5, only lost 2.
Oh, this has been fun. Been a speed game, great scoring opportunities, big hits. showing time and time again that hockey is a board game, B-O-A-R-D.
But good discipline. It was interesting that the one time when it took a penalty, it cost Anaheim.
Mm-hmm. And another face-off in the Anaheim end of the ice coming. 34 seconds left. Sunday afternoon.
And this is first round stuff, Jake.
Yeah.
This is first round. You can see why the players, what a thrill it is to win this Stanley Cup. You go through 2 months of this. Time it's over, you are done.
It is a marathon. Geared off with the puck now. Hits it high, up, out, lands on edge. Spins, rolls, not far enough for icing. Temple Numinen has cleared the zone. They're not back with now 19 seconds. And it comes to center ice. All Korea picked it off the board. Shot it over Dinnick. Numinen back on it, now running. And it's going to be called, having been knocked out of the air with a stick well over the waist and shoulder level. Today's game has been produced by Pete Macheskin. We're not finished yet, Pete. Directed by Michael Frank, our associate director, Mike Roig, and our broadcast associate, Michael Fitzgerald. Thanks to them. Thanks to all the people on cameras and videotape and audio. All the jobs covered by our crew this season. Our technical producer, Dan Rotani, who has such a fabulous crew to work with. Our studio show, produced by Nancy Bernstein, directed by Bob Levy. The senior producer of Fox Sports is Bill Brown. And the executive producers of Fox Sports are Ed Gorin and David Hill. Thank you, one and all. This has been great.
Well, the controversy downstairs right now is Paul Kariya looked up at the clock just as the puck was frozen, the whistle blew, and a full second or so came off, and I think they're going to add another second, maybe a little bit more, onto the clock. And of course, that's going to favor Anaheim because the faceoff is in Phoenix's zone.
Anaheim rolled the dice, sitting on a 2-0 lead, going to the third. Shannon has scored. Tkachuk has scored. Full strength goals, both of them. They've got a second.
And Jansen's out there. Jansen's the big draw guy. They put one full second. That was 6-2, went to 7-2.
Jansen wins the draw. Mironov steps into one hole. Catching glove saved by Javi Bulin. The Bulin wall is just fine.
Well, that was absolutely perfectly executed. The face-off win by Jansen's. Back to Mironov, who walked in around, but no one could get to the front. He has got a cannon,
hasn't he?
Man, it just... I mean, Javi Bulin had to move out. Javi Bulin made a good save there. You see the wall that Anaheim put up.
Dmitry Mironov, that's his brother Boris, who plays for Edmonton. And the two Mironov brothers lost their dad earlier this season. They're back to Russia for a few days for the funeral services. Here in the morning, returned and have really brought their games up, both of them. Jansen's knocked down on the faceoff. We are going to overtime in game six. What a comeback by the home team, and especially Captain Keith Tkachuk.
Well, Tkachuk's the hero on the power play. You see, Tkachuk. Now, just watch Tkachuk. This is what a goal scorer does. They go to the open spots.
So that's our story. Two in the third after two in the second by Anaheim, and we'll be back.
Coyotes battle. James Brown along with Dave Maloney.
Boy, there's a lot going on here, especially in the third period. Paul Kariya, he was a factor, scored the game's first goal, the power play off his own rebound right there, top shelf. That's Paul Kariya, the leader of the Ducks. Here we've got Jeremy Roenick, the biggest play of the game, knee on knee with Ted Drury. Left the game in the second period. Injury not yet determined. In the meantime, we go down, Ducks in front of the net. Brian Bellas is going to come in and knock this one in. That looked like a 2-0 lead was all he wrote. This is Keith Tkachuk all along. Johnny on the spot as Tamo Solani was highlighted in the highlight. Out of position, killing a penalty. Three Ducks behind the net. 2-2, and boy, what a hockey game.
I know you had commented prior to this tied affair in overtime that Anaheim really was playing the better of the two.
Really, the first two periods, Anaheim was clearly the better team. They were quicker. They showed a little more grit, believe it or not, and tenacity around the puck. But going into the series, I'd felt that the Coyote Club was a little more experienced, a little savvy, and a little deeper than an Anaheim club. And I think we saw that in the third period. They got the goal from Shannon. That gave them a little life. Goal late in the power play. We're heading to overtime.
And dug deeper, overcoming the Jeremy Roenick injury.
Absolutely.
For sure. All right, folks, in St. Louis today, the Red Wings looking to try to close out the series.
Well, Brett Hull, who was St. Louis's best player, that's the way you got to stop him, Konstantinov. This is the second period, put Detroit ahead 2-1. Sandstrom finds Shanahan off the right of Grant Fuhr. Now, big play in the second period. Turgeon's left skate in the crease before the puck. That would have made it 2-2, but they went upstairs to the video. Brett Hull said, come on, man, give me a chance. Didn't work right there. This was the third one. Put it out of reach for the Blues. Kurt Maltby with his first playoff goal. Shaking hands after Detroit. On to the next round with a 3-1 win in Game 6 in St. Louis, JB.
All right, that is exactly the case there. Dallas and Edmonton, an outstanding game that took place earlier today. We will bring you the highlights of that one, as well as an interview with the guy who scored the game winner, Mike Modano, after this. As we welcome you back to the Fox Television Center, along with Dave Maloney, I'm James Brown. One of the outstanding game played today, Dallas and Edmonton. Let's bring you the highlights.
Well, they're going back to Dallas for Game 7. Boy, it was a knockdown slugout affair. This is the game's first goal. Leighton beats Joseph over the short side, right shoulder, 1-0 Dallas. 1-1 right here. Bookberger finds big Mike Greer rumble to the front of the net. Tie score first period. Into the second we go. Verbeek finds Bassin in front. Bassin 2-1 Dallas. Good play by Verbeek. Off the faceoff, a clean draw. Lindgren finds Tchaikovsky, beats Moog, all tied at 2. This is late in the third period, folks. Mike Modano, his fourth of the series. Good job staying with the puck by Modano. Throws it to the net. 3-2 Dallas win. Tuesday night, Game 7. Dallas, Texas. Somebody's going to win this one on Tuesday.
As Mike Modano goes, so goes Dallas. And our guys caught up with Mike Modano after the game.
Thanks very much, JB. The Dallas Stars have tied their series with Edmonton 3 games apiece, a 3-2 victory. And joining us downstairs, the hero who scored his second game-winning goal of the series, Mike Modano. And Mike, first of all, congratulations on the victory. Edmonton tied the score late in the second period. What did Coach Ken Hitchcock say in between periods 2 and 3?
He really didn't say too much. I think it was just more or less the guys were talking. I think we knew what we had to do. It's 20 minutes all we have, and lay it on the line. I mean, give it all we got and see what happens and let the pieces fall. But we kind of lost a draw there to tie it up late in the second, so I kind of felt, try to get one back myself.
Well, you did just that, Mike. Great effort for you. Take us through the goal, a key part of the third period with you scoring from far out.
Well, Yari was making some traffic in front, and I just felt like I wanted to get to my forehand and get a shot on Joseph, and I got it through. Looked like it went off Dougie Waite's stick and just kind of redeflected a little bit, but, again, we just want to throw it at the net and see what happens, and finally got a break leading our way, finally.
Is it an emotional victory for this team, finally getting to Curtis Joseph and getting the win?
I think so. I think it's been he's been their backbone of this team. He's kind of kept us through the series. He's been carrying them on his shoulder. So we just wanted to get those third and fourth shots, kind of work on them pretty hard and throw everything we have on onto the net. If we didn't have a play, just throw it up there and get some rebounds, get some traffic, and finally paid off. I mean, we've worked at him hard. He's been a key player for many years, and he was tough to even beat last summer in the World Cup. So I know how tough he's been. But we finally got the break tonight.
Well, Mike, congratulations on the goal and the victory. Good luck in Game 7 on Tuesday.
Thanks, guys.
Mike Modano, our guest, with the game-winning goal, his fourth goal of the series. Dallas Stars over the Edmonton Oilers 3-2 as they tie the series at 3. JB, back to you.
All right, Kenny, and Mike Modano is a key player indeed. When he scores at least a goal, Dallas is 25-5-4. We're going to take you back to Phoenix for overtime as the quest for the cup continues right here on Fox. Dave Maloney, JB, we'll be right here. Trust us.
Welcome back to Phoenix, where our score after regulation time tied. The Ducks 2, the Coyotes 2. We're headed for overtime, but first, a look at the Bud Ice statistics.
Look at the scoring chances, 11-10, very solid defensive game. Anaheim did not generate much offense in the third period.
When we left at the end of the second period, there was some question, was it 2-0 or 3-0? We thought Teemu Selänne perhaps had put the puck in the net, but look what we've been able to find.
Well, Gerald Dittick, number four, looks like he pulls the puck out before it goes over the line. It was as close as it could get, but it never seemed to show white on that replay. And again on this one, it seems to be even more conclusive that didn't go across, but boy, Jiggs, was it close to being a 3-0 hockey game as we headed into the third period.
Congratulations to the National Hockey League. Making the right call is what they wanted to do, and they did it.
And then, give all the credit in the world to the Phoenix Coyotes. They didn't quit. They stuck with their game plan. They've lost Jeremy Roenick, big leader in the dressing room. But they come back with Shannon's goal. And then on the power play, late in the third, Tkachuk, their leader, ties it up and sends it into overtime.
Phoenix has shown so much character in the third period. Character is like the foundation of a house. It's below the surface. We check in on both goaltenders. That's our positioning here at the America West Arena. And we'll get ready here for the overtime with Anaheim defending the goal to the left. The Coyotes the goal to the right. You want to make a selection now, Mr. McNabb?
Oh, man. You know, I'm a big believer in stars. I'm just going to go right to the top. Korea and Tkachuk. I mean, these are the kind of guys that want to win it. These are the kind of guys that will take the chances that you need to take to win a hockey game.
We're not going to get a whole lot of argument. Here's Ruchin moving the puck out. Selänne chasing it. Nieminen was back to clear the way from his former roommate when they were together in Winnipeg. This is J.J. Daniel. Up ahead on the rush, Correa. Selänne held the line. Onside, the shot blocked and cleared by Dittick. Gerald Dittick moves it for Tkachuk. Two men back, Tkachuk. Trying to cut in off the boards. Couldn't do it. Nice defensive play. Dallas turned him around and was all over him. The puck loose now for Steve Ruchin. Right, 45 seconds of sudden death overtime will be here till somebody scores to win it. Icing the call against Anaheim. Well, in the regular season, here are the overtime records for the two teams. Anaheim didn't lose. 3 wins, 13 ties. Don Hayes, Phoenix Coyotes, they went for it more often.
They shot from the hip, Jiggs. Those are unbelievable numbers. 5, 4, and 7. That's just wide open hockey. Jiggs, it used to be in the old days that overtimes were over so quickly.
Yeah.
It used to be the first 4 or 5 minutes of the game, of the overtime, they'd be done. Now, because the teams play overtime in the regular season, they're used to doing it. So they don't make the same kind of early mistakes. Sometimes it takes forever.
That was Sackle that fired that long shot. Bobby Bullen and Darren Channing clears it out. Ronning moves it up to Gartner. Trying to cut in off the right wing board. Short angle shot. In the Bears' gates and now under the catching glove.
It just tinged off the side of the net, not the post, and came back towards. See this shot right there? Hits the thing. And if you bear good, just good presence to look down and find it. He didn't slide back. If he slides back right here, he might have pulled it with him. Gardner just unleashes that shot. As he's been doing this league since 1979. See, the side of the net, not really the post, comes back under Hebert, and now those all-important defensive zone face-offs.
To the left of D.A. Bear, won by Jenny, a shot from the point, got down, hit somebody in front, and cleared out of there. Aaron Quint went back, doubled it up ahead to Keith Tkachuk, who had to turn to find it. Now to Jenny, on to Quint. Quint rushes into the Anaheim zone, shot along with the fist. A.J. Daniel pulled it away from a check, pulls it up the near side. That's Reichel going cross ice. Dallas after it. Anaheim able to move it out. Here's Jenny. Struggled to get over the line, and the puck was knocked away from him. And it's changing up here. Now Anaheim trying to make their changes. Quint has shot it in deep. And Shannon in after it, put it back to the net. Stapleton can't get loose. Just recover the puck. Luchin able to spot Correa moving to center ice. He shot it in wide of the net. Bobby Bullen, well, he kind of decided that he was going to play it. Thought first about covering it. And that was really strange. It ended up on the boards behind the net over in the far corner.
Very unusual play. It looked like Kareem was going to dump it in, but then he shot it off the end boards. And Bobby Bullen, I don't think he felt Rushin coming in on it. Because Rushin almost got his stick down in time to get a good poke at it.
Appeared like he changed his mind, didn't it? You can't do that. Although he did and got away with it. Newman now. Moving out of the zone. Here's Timo Salotti. I do move through center ice. He's played it in off Newman's skates. Well, Dittick for Phoenix. Gave it to Shannon. To Dittick. Tries the far side. Stapleton and Mac can't move up in time. And this is Biernock. Nice checking job by Stapleton. And then it came outside the line. They're trying to get Stapleton up there. Back onside. And whoa! That long shot by Corkum. That was from another area goal. Here are the Ducks moving to center. Bellows got it into the zone. Teberdoski got it out. Ryan Bellows plays it cross ice, giving his team an opportunity to make some changes and comfort. Sadowski went right to Bellows to puck back to the point for a long shot that went well wide of the net. Game on to running. The Coyotes get no further than the center ice strike. Moves it on to Yari Curry. Flips it into the zone. That one bounced for Teberdoski, who almost gave it away cleanly to Bellows. Ronning didn't get it out of the zone. Not loose on the left wing boards. Over comes Chris King for Phoenix. Puts it high out to center. Little English on that. Anaheim was able to move it out. Phoenix in the middle of a player change again. Ronning with a pass for Chris King. And the whistle sounds offside, the first signal from the officiating staff. Earlier this afternoon here on Fox Sports, you saw Detroit defeat St. Louis 3-1 and win their best of seven series, 4-2. And you saw Mike Modano come back with a goal to defeat Edmonton 3-2, of course, Game 7 in that series. So it's all set up for next week. The quest for the Cup continuing on Fox. Exciting regional coverage of the Stanley Cup Conference semifinals. We don't know where, but we do know when. It'll be 2 o'clock Eastern, 11 o'clock Pacific. Check local listings for the game and time in your area right here on Fox. And the possibilities are, sir.
Montreal is gone, as we mentioned. Pittsburgh and Mario are gone. Florida, Stanley Cup finalists last year, gone. And now, it'll all depend on Buffalo and Ottawa later tonight. Who is going to play who? And that is going to make up some very interesting. If Ottawa wins, Ottawa and the upstart, or New Jersey and the upstart Ottawa Senators. And then if Buffalo wins, Jersey and Rangers. Everybody remembers that series they had a couple years ago where the Rangers won the cup. One went to seven games, double overtime.
And here in the West, already assured of a seven-game series with Dallas and Edmonton. What about this one? Long shot in. Blocked. Moore has cleared it out for the Coyotes. There's Janney trying to get loose. Got the puck across the line to Tkachuk. Oh, he couldn't feed it back to Drake. Here's Warren Reichel with a long shot. Seemed to handcuff Bobby Bullen. They don't get it out of the zone. Harpa right around the board. Drake from off the end boards. And the shot taken by Tim Curry. On comes Tkachuk. Tkachuk gave it to Quint. Right of the net. Chuck went right to the goal to form a screen, looked for a tip for a rebound. Puck held in, Stapleton. It's a second chance and shot it high. And Chuck got knocked down at the side of the net. Chuck trying to get out of the zone. They're choked off. That's Dittick, able to send Corkum over the blue line. The puck went to Stapleton. He's met solidly by Reichel. In time, Corkum up with it. On Corkum into Shannon. Shannon with one of the two Phoenix goals in today's game. Martha moved it on, and it's shot down the ice by Reichel. This has enough. Call back for icing. We played 5 minutes and 18 seconds of sudden death overtime.
This time of hockey game, if you don't have a great offensive chance, just put it on net. That's the whole idea. Everybody has the same simple game plan. The shot goes on net, everybody drives towards it. Here's Warren Reichel. He's just going to put it on net and have everybody flood the zone, look for any sort of rebound. Here's a good chance right here. Walks out front, almost grabs a break, throwing it far side.
In overtime, the Ducks have had 5 shots on goal. The Coyotes have had 2. 37-21, the shots on goal in total, favoring Anaheim, and you know the scoring. All 5 previous games, the team with the fewer shots has won. That changed today. That scoring line continues. If it does, the series is over. Mironov drops it back. He got it right back, and then much more for Daniel. Into the middle, Rusin looked up, Vinnick was coming at him. That's Corkum using the boards to get it out, and Mironov has gone all the way back. Turned it over. Corkum across the line. Offside! Shannon thought he had regained the blue line. The linesman, Knox and Lazarowicz, say no.
You talk about the players. As we watch the offsides right here, you have to remember that the referees and linesmen play the whole game. They're on the ice the whole time, and they continue to make good calls. This was argued by Phoenix, but the puck is over before he got back. Great call by the linesman, and it's a long day's work for these guys, and they should get full marks for the effort they put in. As the tension builds on the ice, they know it, they can feel it, and they're still making the good calls.
On Koharski's last game of the playoffs, last Wednesday night, game 4 of the Pittsburgh-Philadelphia series. Two linesmen work game 5 of Colorado. So game 5 at Anaheim the other night, didn't they? Long shot here, blocked. Loose puck in front. Coyotes struggling to get it out. Anaheim cleared it all the way down. Mironov thought he was giving it to the point man, and he had moved out of that position. Harpa, some help, got it to center ice. Podolski, and now moved on to Tkachuk. Long shot, he plucked it wide. Even Karpa over for the Mighty Ducks. Southland went too far, but Bellows has touched it. That avoids an icing call. Anaheim making player changes. Nice pass, here's running across the line. The puck knocked away, still in the Anaheim zone. Back to Ronnie. Couldn't get it to Gartner in time. Now Gartner gets a weak shot away. Hillary Bear went to play it. Mike Gartner, number 22, hard around toward Darren Quick, covering the left point. Indeed, Gartner. Gartner trying to get it loose. Yeah, Jim McKenzie there with him, and couldn't get it to Phoenix's tough guy.
Big Jim McKenzie just turned right away. He was not about to get involved with Carper. You never know which way it's going to go. The referee starts to make his call.
Hello. Harpa and McKenzie. And the linesman putting the players back on the players' bench. Just part of the job. There are the numbers. 2-2. Up top, it shows that we're 7 minutes and 18 seconds into the first overtime. On Koharski auditioning for another officials commercial.
You know, it's very interesting. He was talking to the bench for saying, control Karpa. I'm giving you a break right now, but control him because I'm going to get you next time. But that's controlling the game. Good job by Koharski. I mean, you know, last thing he wants to do is make a call like that that's going to decide this hockey game.
had the benefit of being seated beside a guy who has a Stanley Cup playoff overtime goal.
Oh, there is no bigger thrill.
Oh, there it is! Korea wins it in overtime! Just blasted it by Javi Bullen. There will be a seventh game in Anaheim. Can you believe that?
Can this kid make things happen in a hurry? That, Jake, there was nothing going on. There was nothing going on. The puck was just dumped down the ice, and all of a sudden, there's Korea, and we go back to the pond for game seven, and is that play is going to be rocking. You think this play was rocking for game six.
7:29 of sudden death overtime. This is the game winner.
Boom. He hit the goalpost on his first shot to the far side from the right wing, now from the left wing. Javi Bullen got a little piece of it, but not enough. And the little guy comes through with a huge goal.
Each team has one on the other guy's ice now as Paul Kariya gets his fifth of the series. Assist to Salani and Ruchin at 7:29 of sudden death overtime. The Mighty Ducks, after leading 2-0 and then getting themselves into a 2-2 tie, celebrate. They win it 3-2. We'll return to wrap it up from Phoenix right after these words. 3-2 final.